Just about ready for the opening faceoff here in Game 5. We know the Eastern Conference Final is at least going to a Game 6. Will we go to a Game 6 in the West? Dustin Brown and the Kings will have something to say about that. If they win, they have a berth on the Stanley Cup Final against the survivor of the Rangers and the Devils. The Coyotes must win to survive. And it's Antoine Vermette controlling the opening faceoff ahead to Bodker. Now it's Vermette sending it in behind Jonathan Quick. Knocks it down with a paddle of the goal stick. Moves it to Drew Doughty.
Good job there by Jonathan Quick. That's not an easy one there, especially with the partitions like that. It can go for a big bounce. Good hand-eye coordination behind the net.
And look at this push by Phoenix early on. That's what made it successful in Game 4. They were much better in the forecheck.
Oh, a takeaway there by Doan. He does that so well, coming from behind players with the puck. But it rolled right into Jonathan Quick. And speaking of Quick, let's take a look at the numbers for our Honda Pilot. Starting goaltenders, the two guys that have gone the entire way since the start of the playoffs for their respective teams. You see their numbers in the series. The biggest difference, shots faced. Mike Smith has faced 60 more shots than Jonathan Quick in this series, which makes that 9-4 save percentage maybe a little bit more impressive than the slightly higher 9-4-5 that Jonathan Quick has. Face-off control by the Kings, taken away by the Coyotes, but LA gets it right back, and it's flipped back through center ice. It gets by Yandle, picked up now by Derek Morris. Morris hard around on the far side, and there is Martin Hansel, who returned to the lineup in Game 4 after that one-game suspension. Quick moves it for Mitchell, who takes a bump, and it's around the boards, taken on the left-wing side by Dustin Penner. His pass is blocked by Ray Whitney. Whitney hands it off. Morris looking for Bravada, but Penner stepped in the way. Now it's picked up by Richards. Back to the line. Mitchell slides it across. Voinoff didn't have a shooting lane. Sends it deep. Bouncing puck. Penner. Now it's picked up by Richards. Hands it off for Mitchell coming in. Fanned on a shot attempt. He wanted to get it to the front of the net. Now Richards pass intercepted by Hansel. Slides it ahead to Whitney. He's got Yandle coming quick up the left side. Yandle sends it for Bravada. Cuts it. Oh! And he missed it high. Not sure. Quick got a piece of that. But Jonathan Quick, as he always does, came out to challenge the dangerous Radim Bravada.
Bravada missed the net in Game 4 from the slot. Here, on a perfect 3-on-2, he tries to go high to the glove side. Whitney goes to one side. Yandle pulls up. The weak side player is Bravada. And this one just goes over the net. Yep. Oh, what a classic two-pad slide attempt anyway by the athletic Quick.
Yeah, that was just a plain old miss there by Bravada. He had some clean cut chances in Game 4. He hasn't had any points in the last 7 games. Just not feeling it yet.
A guy that scored 35 goals in the regular season. Second highest point getter behind Ray Whitney on this team that basically does it by committee.
And the problem, how that play started, was Mike Richards made a real bad pass out of the corner in the middle of the ice for the turnover and caught all three of the LA forwards.
Trevor Lewis kicks it ahead. Now Jared Stoll is checked at center ice. Klesla and Schlemko, the defense tandem. So the one change for the Phoenix Coyotes from the Game 4 lineup. David Schlemko is back in, replacing Adrian O'Coin. Still bothered by a lower body injury. Didn't play a full complement of minutes when he was in the lineup in Game 4. Not able to go here tonight.
Well, Dave Tippett going with the experienced guy, Schlemko, who's actually played well when he's been subbed in throughout these playoffs instead of Michael Stone, the youngster.
Jepchura bounces this one in on Quick, and he decides to hold it in the glove.
Last thing either one of these teams want to do is go into a scrum and be the only one called, as the officials are doing that more and more. So you don't want to go in there and be the one called. But let's go back to this chance again and keep your eye on the toe. You know, on second look, Brian, I think that went off the left toe of Jonathan Quick. There.
Oh, yes.
And you see the way
it changed direction.
You know, it's coming up there. It's flat. Now
it
turns.
He had it under the bar.
Oh, my goodness.
Also, looking at that banger, you're surprised maybe he didn't fake the shot and just go to that quick backhand, because he loves that move on the shootouts and breakaways.
Yeah, he had a spot kick, though. And he's got a big curve on that stick. He likes to go high. Obviously had his mind set up, but boy, Rogie Vachon would have been proud of that two-pad stacker there.
Dustin Brown shot is blocked and back the other way now. The Coyotes could have an odd man break, a 4-on-2. Here comes Bodker with speed. He holds up, he waits. He hands it off for a shot here. The net is off. Drew Doughty's going to be called for a penalty. Drew Doughty ran into the net behind Jonathan Quick. And if there's such a thing as a good penalty, this is one.
The Coyotes are utilizing their weak side forward and a weak side D, jumping up into the play. And on the rush by Bodger's got tremendous speed. Doughty turns, spins, and he actually loses an edge right there. But because it's a complete scoring chance and he knocks the net off its moorings here on your left-hand side, and the scoring chance comes there, they end up giving him the delay. But it's very clear that Doughty lost an edge right there. He didn't do that on purpose. He just blew a tire.
Yeah, I think he was just trying to get that skate underneath him there. That was a heck of a play by Bodker. Doughty took a gamble, tried to knock it off his stick, didn't quite get about it. Bodker make a great pass.
Power play is brought to you by Bacardi for the Coyotes. Here is Doan out of the corner, but it rolls off his stick. And it's Stoll that clears it back the other way. Phoenix Coyotes just one power play goal in this series, but it was a huge one. It came in the Game 4 win. They are just 1-for-13 with a man advantage as Whitney plays it ahead into the L.A. zone. Bodker with his speed will get there. Drops it back down to Antoine Vermette. Good patience with it in the corner. Sends it back to the line now. Oliver Ekman-Larsson. Ray Whitney. Back for Ekman-Larsson, has some room for a shot, but knocked down, picked up, Doan fanned on it as he tried to get it back quickly to the front of the net. Whitney, high slot, Bodker.
Oh, what a play by Kopitar.
Good recovery by Bodker, though, and then Kopitar with a stick to block the pass that was intended across.
Yeah, so it starts out with a good shot blocked by big Matt Green, and then it ends with two good plays by Kopitar.
And Kopitar knocks down Verbata in the neutral zone, and Kopitar hit by Martin Hansel.
And you should see right here at the gate as Shane Doan was changing. Dustin Brown dusted him right into the open gate here. Doan turned around and took that number, I can tell you that much.
Oh, they know each other well. The two guys, low center gravity, good hitters, ferocious. And then Kopitar has his head down on the near side. Here's the first play on the penalty kill. Relentless pursuit by Kopitar the first time, but Bodker fights him off and gets it in. But look at the stick in the lane on the second time, knocking out of the zone. And then Kopitar right in the neutral zone, banging Verbata. And then he gets banged on his own down below us. Hansel comes in and finishes his check. That had to hurt, boy. He put himself in a vulnerable spot, reaching forward, so he was kind of leaning down like that. Big Hansel got him with a shoulder.
Talk about two technically perfect checks that he made, though. One inside the zone and one in the neutral zone.
Here's Verbata with a loose puck and a shot and a save by Quick. Now it's Hansel sending it back to the line. Yandel to the corner. Verbata hands it off. Hansel with a drive. He scores! Martin Hansel on the power play makes it 1-0.
Seconds left on the Doughty minor. Doughty having a conversation with the referee, and he has a right for that as he slid into the post and they gave him the delay of game. But the first shot there was by Verbata, and again, trying to go high. But 17 makes a terrific pass in the high slot. Look at the reaction from Martin Hansel, leaping into the air after he rifles this one in.
Well, in this whole sequence, notice how many times the LA Kings have to go from low to high, back to low, and back out high again. That makes real tough coverage.
Taylor Pyatt in front of the net. No chance at all for Quick. That was a good screen by Pyatt.
Here is King now circling the goal. Tries to wrap it to the front. He got it there, but Smith took it away down low. First of the series for Hansel. His fourth of the playoffs. And now the Coyotes start it back the other way. Corey Korpakovsky pushes it ahead. Tries to get around Martinez. Stoll is there for puck support for Los Angeles. What a forecheck here by the Coyotes in the early going. Now Lenko pushes it along. It's blocked, and King hands it off. And Trevor Lewis now slides it ahead. Doesn't connect with King. This will be icing on the touch-up by Rusty Kleslin.
Well, Verbata's off to his best start and continuing on a solid performance in Game 4. Oh, this one here changed directions a little bit at the very end. Good one-timer, screen in front. Past the stick side, and the goaltender going from his post to the high slot, always difficult, especially with traffic in front of you. Hard to track where that puck's coming from.
Verbata and Yandel on the assist, faceoff win by the Coyotes. Here's Verbata with it again. Takes it to the corner. Tries to make a move on Matt Green, who eliminates him, and now Jared Stoll will jump to the loose puck. That assist by Yandel is ninth of the playoff, which ties him for the league lead. Hansel with a second hop at it. It was blocked and picked up by Whitney, his centering attempt. Didn't get to the front. Now Stoll knocks it away from Hansel. Derek Morris steps up. He's checked by Dwight King, and it's Stoll who clears it for LA out to center ice. Lead pass for Whitney. He is onside. Slides it wide to Jonathan Quick. Doughty, 1-2 there by Vermette. it comes to Scuderi. Scuderi checked from behind. That was Doan again that lifted the stick. Now Doan slides it across. The pass was behind Botker. Oliver Ekman-Larsson sends it in wide of Jonathan Quick. Now he has it. Shots are 4-1 Phoenix, and they have the 1-0 lead. And Engblom had just mentioned that Verbata had gone 7 games without a point. And he gets an assist there. That was his longest pointless streak since October of 2010. He's been a consistent performer here in the desert. Willie Mitchell back to get it now for Los Angeles.
Dave Tippett was hoping following game 4 that good things were to come from Verbata after he greatly struggled in the first 3 games. But he had a couple of chances, as I mentioned, missed the net on the one. But here he's been all over it with the assist on Hanzel's goal from the slot.
On the power play, second power play goal of the series for the Coyotes. First goal of this game 5, 1-0 Phoenix. There is nothing like hockey at this time of year. We've got it covered for you here on the NBC Sports Network. Game 5 tomorrow. Coverage begins at 7. The game at 8 o'clock. Game 5 between the Devils and the Rangers. And if there's a game 6, we'll have it for you here on the NBC Sports Network from LA Thursday night. Beginning at 8 Eastern with the game starting at 9 Eastern. Kipchura hands it off now. The forecheck continues for the Coyotes. Puck deflected off one of the officials. Brad Watson and Kevin Pollock are the referees here tonight. Here's Kipchura. Hands it off down low for Boyd Gordon. A wraparound stopped by Quick.
That's a good stop there. He had to push hard from his left to his right to get that wraparound. You know, the last 2 games, LA's been challenged by defending from below the goal line, and that's where Phoenix is starting everything from below the goal line and really protecting the puck with their body and getting chances.
And LA practiced that this morning, Panger, didn't they?
They
had their forwards and defensemen coming out from behind the net, getting Jonathan Quick used to it.
Here is Penner now across the line. Makes a little move on Ekman-Larsson, tried to throw it to the front. Whitney was there in perfect position. Outlets it to an open area at center ice. Scuderi hustled over. Now Roosevelt plays it ahead. Martin Hanzel for Verbata. He sends it across. One-timer from Whitney. Just wide of the glove. Here's Verbata with it again. Drops it back. Another chance for Whitney.
Oh!
What a stop by Quick.
Quick reaches back to his left. What a brilliant save that is. The Coyotes are doing a great job of getting it down low and then to the high slot. Whitney thinks he's got the far side wide open. Quick does the splits. You see his athleticism and reaching back against the grain. 2 chances. That one just barely went wide. Verbata to the high slot. Look at that. Just reaching back, falling forward, and then the puck's right between his legs.
He had to look back just a little bit to get the puck set, and he hammered that one. And look how Jonathan Quick is kind of falling forward on that play. But Whitney makes a heck of a save. LA's not tracking the Phoenix Coyotes very well inside their own zone. They got their feet spread. They're going to have to up their tempo in their own end.
Good point. Boy, the line of Hanzel, Whitney, Verbata have accounted for 5 shots and 4 chances here already as this puck off of Pyatt deflects in on Jonathan Quick, and he has to cover up.
The sense of energy and control has been very evident since the opening sequence in the first shift for the Phoenix Coyotes. This is Phoenix, the first shift. Look how deep they are. 3 guys deep on the rush, catching the LA Kings a couple of times with players up the ice, getting them in scramble mode. This was the outnumbered attack, and Drew Doughty ended up sliding into the net and knocking it off. The ensuing power play that happened, and Hanzel in the deep slot hammering it. Right now, Phoenix in control, LA chasing.
Lanko and Stoll tie each other up. Pyatt gets to the loose puck. That's one of those 50-50 pucks. When it's not a clean faceoff win, here's Korpakoski trying to spin away from Doughty. Korpakoski to the corner, angles it off the board. Yandel slaps it in deep. Lanko had it in his skates. Stoll tries to clear. Yandel holds it in for a shot. Change direction. And a left pad saved by Jonathan Quick.
Now, Jonathan Quick is doing what he's done all season long. He's keeping them in a tight game right now as we, again, look at the race to 2 goals.
Here is Taylor Pine across the line. Takes it deep. Up there by Scuderi. Now rolls it along the end boards. Vermette and Doan out on the ice. Pyatt goes to the benches. Botker completes the line change. It comes to Botker in the high slot. Gets a shot away that bounced off of Doan and wide of the net. Doan with a big hit on Kopitar. And now the puck is cleared by Trevor Lewis to center ice.
It's all about sustained pressure right now. And the Phoenix Coyotes are playing a game that we have not seen play against the LA Kings.
Doan is checked by Boynoff. Williams is there. Now Vermette joins the fray. The puck's still just inside the LA zone. Doan with his skates trying to protect it. He's looking around. How long will the officials let it go? Finally, they blow the whistle, and they're taking it outside the zone.
Well, now it's all about adjustments for the veteran head coach, Daryl Sutter. Very calm behind the bench. He's looking at it, and all he is looking over to his left, knowing that the play has been in his zone. So you wonder at what point that Daryl's going to look over, maybe make a subtle change. They're struggling right now inside their own zone. There's been an onslaught. And luckily for Daryl Sutter, Jonathan Quick has been very, very sharp.
Daryl Sutter, he said he had no problems with his team's effort at all in game four. He said, we just didn't score. We had plenty of shots, plenty of chances.
Oh, yeah, they did. Tremendous chances.
Here comes Botcher. Again, cuts to the middle. Dustin Brown gets a stick on it. Sweeps it to the middle of the ice. One of the Coyotes got a stick on it. That was Botcher again. He's been everywhere. Now he sends it out along the near boards. Vermette had it taken away by Dustin Brown, and Voinov now for Ante Kopitar as the Kings try to get something going in the Phoenix end of the ice. Dustin Brown. Now Kopitar wanted to get it to Voinov, who is starting to move in from his right point position. Now it's chipped along the board. Voinov holding the line, battling with Botker. Ekman Larson flipped it, but didn't get it out the first time. Second effort, he does. Doan's going to race for this puck. Willie Mitchell has the angle on him. Now it's knocked away by Mitchell. Out to the line. It's held in by Schlemko. Sent back in front. Blocked by Voinov. And he sends it back now for Jordan Nolan, who was pressured by Martin Hansel. Hansel takes him to the boards. Kings, though, get to the puck, and it's sent back into the Phoenix end.
I think there's too many men on the ice for the Los Angeles Kings right here.
Oh, I think you're right. They're arguing. Brian Engblom with Dave Tippett when we come back. Time now for Edward Jones FaceTime. Brian Engblom with Dave Tippett, who talks about handling the forecheck.
Well, we're finding a way to turn over some pucks with some strong one-on-one play, some good forecheck, and it's leading to a lot of offensive zone time. So we got to continue that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
There is no question that Dave Tippett has talked an awful lot about sustained pressure. All the teams here, there's only four left. I mean, if you don't have sustained pressure, if all you have is pop gun offense, you're not going to have much success, and you're not going to put much fatigue in the other team's goaltender. But Phoenix has had their best push so far in this series.
Too many men on the ice was the call on LA. Second power play for the Phoenix Coyotes. Quiznos power play for Phoenix, and here's Vermette trying to sweep it to the front. It bounces high in the air. Picked up by Mitchell, taken back by Doan. He sends it across the LA zone. Ekman Larson able to keep it away from Jared Stoll. Now here's Shane Doan with it. Backhands it out to the right point. Whitney back for Doan. A bouncing puck is settled down by Mitchell. Mitchell calm under pressure, able to send it all the way down the ice. Brad Richardson is serving the too many men on the ice penalty for Los Angeles. Mike Smith doesn't connect with Doan here. And what is normally a strong part of Mike Smith's game right here leads to an icing.
Well, we go back to the minor penalty against the Los Angeles Kings, and you see right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and the puck is over right there by the linesman. So I saw immediately the linesman obviously makes that call, and it's a matter of about maybe 7-8 feet there for Daryl Sutter, and the puck happens to go right in that vicinity.
So now it is Vermette for the Coyotes. Kopitar wins it cleanly back for a shot here that doesn't get through. Now Doughty will hammer one. Score! Another shorthanded goal for the Los Angeles Kings on just their second shot of the game. That one finds its way in, and what a huge boost for Los Angeles.
And Kopitar has been LA's best player so far in this game, and he gets the tip in. Good selection here by Doughty after the faceoff win by Kopitar. Gets some help there. A fanned-on shot by Brown. The shot, it's going wide, and the redirection comes back between the legs. Real difficult play for a goaltender. He's expecting it to his left. A perfect redirection off the bottom of the blade and right between the legs. So for Daryl Sutter, Brian, his power play's not working. Might as well score shorthanded.
Well, they say special teams, it doesn't matter which one. It seems like Ante Kopitar certainly has come ready to play. There are several Kings that are still struggling to get their game going so far, but this guy has come out like a bear, and he scores a huge goal to get his team back in this one because they've been faltering pretty poorly so far.
LA has scored 6 power play goals in the playoffs. That's their 5th shorthanded goal. So they have scored more shorthanded goals than they've allowed the opponents to score on the power play. Just tremendous timing. Daryl Sutter talked about this morning. He said, I try to put a positive spin on this puck. Is this going to be a delay of game? Does it hit the glass or does it go all the way down the ice and hit the netting?
Well, there's no doubt that Phoenix wants them to look at it. They were just banging on the boards right away as soon as the puck went over the glass.
You know, I thought I heard it clang off the glass before hitting the netting from here.
They made the ruling. They're saying it was a deflection.
Yeah, and not from any stick, but I think it went off the end glass. Obviously, from this angle, if it goes over top, it's obviously a delay of game penalty, but it's straight there. Yeah, really.
Hard to tell, but I thought I heard something, too.
I thought, I thought there was some sound there, so obviously a tough one to judge, and you're not expecting a shot from that far away, so you have to make a quick reaction to that kind of play. Not reviewable, of course.
Kopitar's second goal of the series, fifth of the playoffs. Doughty and Brown assisting as this play is offside. And boy, when you're a team like LA, you're on the road, your goaltender, you pointed out, Panger, is giving you a chance to stay in the game. You need some kind of a spark. And, you know, when we went to that last break, Mike Smith made a beeline to the dressing room. We're not sure why. We're assuming it was an equipment problem, but you have to wonder whether he was, you know, mentally just off a little bit to rush in there, do whatever he had to do, and get back in time for the commercial timeout.
The athletic trainer, Jason Gervais, went in there. So that was, it was interesting. I know we've seen other goaltenders, Ty Conklin, who this year is with the Detroit Red Wings, he would actually have to go to the washroom in stoppages, which is a lot of work.
On the far side, Vermette bumps with Doughty, and that play is offside.
You go back to that goal that Kopitar scored. Kopitar won the faceoff, and he was up against Antoine Vermette. Vermette's been a machine for Phoenix in these playoffs. Vermette, 60% in the faceoff circle throughout the playoffs. Up against Kopitar there. He gets a one swing at it, but Kopitar, strong on his hands, gets good puck possession of it, and they were able to control it after that. There's always those battles in the faceoff circle that are critical inside the zones.
Yeah, the timing was right there for Kopitar, wasn't it? Because Vermette was maybe too quick on it. He had his stick there. Pops over top and a clean win by Kopitar, who's been fantastic so far in this game.
Now Smith settles it down, is picked up by Ekman Larson. They've announced a scoring change on the Phoenix goal. They've given it to Taylor Pyatt. You guys mentioned that you thought it looked like a change direction. Hansel and Verbata given the assist. And a bouncing puck here. Richards able to clear. And the too many men on the ice penalty, which could have been very costly for the LA Kings. They managed to get another shorthanded goal to tie this game 5 up at 1 apiece. Bouncing puck on quick. He has to be careful, and he is.
Well, Damon Lankow has done a real good job in sliding up there with Korpikoski and Pyatt. Normally Gordon was there, but for the last game, Lankow snuck in there. And they've been a good line. We talked an awful lot about the King, Stoll, and Lewis line, and even the captain, Shane Doan, said, man, that line has been awfully good all over the ice. Well, now the Kopitar line, and Kopitar himself has taken upon himself to change the course of this game.
Here's Kopitar, sent it to the front. Smith got a piece of it. Now it's picked up by Dustin Brown. He wheels and fires, and a save by Mike Smith. As LA now with a bit of confidence after that tying goal. This puck sent across on the far side. Doughty's not going to be able to hold it in.
In the last two games, the LA Kings, especially this top line of Kopitar, have not been able to carry the puck in the zone nearly as effectively as they did in the first two games. That's one thing that Phoenix shut off. On that last shift, you saw Kopitar go deep. They got it to the net, and they got two chances.
Green fires it into the Coyotes zone. It's picked up by Derek Morris from the spot he scored in game one. The blade of his stick goes about as far as the puck is as the stick snaps. Now it's picked up by Pouliot, who hands it off for Gordon. Drops it back now for Chip Chura. Battling against Green, Chip Chura trying to control it. He drops it back now for Pouliot. Pouliot sends it to the front. Backhanded off the side of the net by Kessler. Fooled some of the fans there. Wraparound try. Quick is down. Puck is still loose. Gordon had a stick on it. Now Boyd Gordon again, separated from the puck as Dwight King, number 74 for Los Angeles, starts it back the other way.
They're making Jonathan Quick really work hard down low, huh? We all talked about how strong his legs are, how hard he trains, and how good he is going post to post, but he's working hard here in this first.
Pouliot drops it back. Kipchura able to get it now. A centering pass for Pouliot just missed connecting. Hard to Hansel out there as the Coyotes are trying to complete a line change. Voinov takes Hansel off the puck. Ekman Larson holds it in momentarily. Now it bounces outside the line of the LA Kings. Regain control. Crowd chanting beat LA from the time the teams took the ice here as this puck deflects up out of the netting and out of play. 5.5 remaining in the first. It's been all Phoenix with a 9-4 shot advantage, but Anze Kopitar with a beautiful redirection of a Drew Doughty shot. Shorthanded, the Kings have tied it. Taylor Pyatt on the left, giving credit for the first goal by the Coyotes on the power play. That was Kopitar who scored shorthanded, so been a special teams first period. Escuderi sends it far side. Richards had it bounce off his stick. And Martin Hansel slides it ahead now for Ray Whitney. Carries into the zone, tried to put it through the skates of Drew Doughty, who would have none of that. It's sent back the other way. And Yandel hit Hansel, but the play was offside as we take a look at our KSC player profile. Shane Doan, fourth player in the 2012 playoffs to score two goals when facing elimination. You see his rank in a lot of areas, shots on goal, hits, penalty minutes. Of course, he had the suspension for the hit on Trevor Lewis back in earlier in the series, and five goals for Shane Doan. I should say the game was conduct. He didn't get suspended as a result of that hit. As the long shot here sails in high and wide of Mike Smith. Roosevelt tying his man up along the boards. Moving down the boards was Doan. Put a hit on Dustin Brown. Brown staying with him. Two of them bump again at center ice. Now Roosevelt played it off the boards. Brown tried to bump it across to a teammate. And now it's picked up by Justin Williams across the line. Here's Brown moving up. Left wing, a drive right over the head of Mike Smith.
A high riser there. Might have glanced off the defense of Roosevelt's
stick. It did. Yeah, it did.
Lead pass for Vodka. Back for Doan. He was hooked on the play. Going to be another power play for the Phoenix Coyotes. Their third straight here in this first period.
Boy, that was Shane Doan going to the net hard, and he's a beast to handle. Voinov had all he could handle, and he figured he better not take a chance there, and he ended up taking a penalty because of it.
It's been the odd man breaks that Phoenix has had against a team that doesn't normally give up odd man breaks. Good quick pass in here. Bodker waits and waits and waits. Doan gets away from his man, Voinov. Voinov stopped skating, didn't he, Brian? And he allowed Doan to get inside.
There's the shot that got deflected, too. Boy, that looked like it went right off the side of the head of Mike Smith. That had a chance to go in. It looked like it might still have been underneath the bar. But, yeah, the quick passing of Phoenix has been a big story in this first period.
Well, that's what Dave Tippett talked about early when all the talk was about the forecheck of the L.A. Kings and L.A. forcing you to do things quicker than you wanted. Dave Tippett said, don't be in too much of a hurry. Don't panic, but you do have to move the puck to beat the pressure. Leap pass for Rivada just offside. And the crowd reacting as Matt Green took him down, but the play was clearly offside.
Yeah, fans didn't understand how that play developed. Offside before, that speed through the middle of the ice. But it's easy to say, have composure with the puck. I mean, the LA Kings are a terrific positional team, and they put you in bad spots, so you feel like you got to get those happy hands going. And that was offside just by a little bit.
And that was a classic example of Verbata was coming from behind. He's the fastest player on the ice in the NHL. Players with the puck realize that the fastest guy gets the puck because he is going to be the most dangerous. That was only half a step offside.
Now Morris far side. Martin Hansel chips it in deep. Look at how quickly Jonathan Quick came out to get a piece of that puck. And now it bounces off of Yandel and it's picked up by Kopitar. Short-handed again, the Los Angeles Kings. Still a minute 20 remaining in the Voinov penalty. And now it's just smartly sent back to center ice to kill some more time.
And even while short-handed, you see the confidence of Doughty. He jumps up in the play. He was down by the hash marks to the right of Smith before curling away, knowing that Kopitar had no play.
Smith clears it ahead. Here's Doan with it. Doan, nice little move on Mitchell. Sends it to the front, broken up by Green. And cleared by Stoll, just over the glove of Keith Yandel.
The heads-up play by Mike Smith, even under pressure with a forechecker on him to lob that puck all the way to the far blue line on an L.A. line change was great.
Now Doan center ice, just over 3 minutes remaining in the period. Knocked off his stick and Richards able to clear it back the other way. Less than 40 seconds remaining in the third power play of this first period for the Phoenix Coyotes. We're tied at one. Pyatt on the power play, Kopitar shorthanded. Ekman Larson now for Ray Whitney. Rink wide, Vermette. pressured by Green, and look how quickly Carter got over there. And again, even shorthanded, the LA Kings can outnumber you at the puck. Now Whitney across the line, hands it off to Doan. Doan hammers this one, it hits a stick and goes up on the netting out of play.
Well, the Los Angeles Kings talk an awful lot about keeping the puck away from Mike Smith, but sometimes you have no choice. And here, he gloves it, puts it down, looks one way, fires it right up the middle. It doesn't just fire it up the middle, it's a saucer. It's perfectly flat. Doan's able to get it, gain the zone, and then he tries to really, he really forced that pass right there, whereas he had play, he had time in the offensive zone. Here's a fake to the forehand, go to the backhand, lure Richards one way, and now that opens up a nice lane right there for the Coyotes.
Talk about a third defenseman back there. Does he ever pass the puck well? That means the line changes of the LA Kings have to be really sharp because you don't know what that guy's going to do.
Coyotes get to another puck after a high faceoff between the centers. Here's Lenko now. Angles it off the boards for Yandel. Sends it far side. One-timer missed by Derek Morris. And out of the box comes Voinov. And back the other way now. Shot in on Smith. He gives up the rebound and then had to kick it out after it bounced off of Colin Frazier, who crashed the net as he does so well. Lopakowski slips by Scuderi. Bounces off another check. His centering pass hits the back of the net.
That was a smart play by Jared Stoll just to put that on net, looking for a rebound, and he got it.
Frazier center ice, waiting for Richardson to get outside. Lobs it in now as Chipchura takes a hit. Lemko plays it up the far side, and it's poked by Gordon out to center ice. Mitchell back to get it. Pressured by Pouliot. Angled off the boards, and Chipchura unable to stop it. This puck rolls. It's picked up by Lemko. They waved off the icing. Three Coyotes are there, two LA Kings. Gordon comes up with it and lobs it out center ice. Skips in front of the LA bench, and Voinov has it now. Hands it off to Mitchell. Alonje Kopitar. Voinov. Angled off the boards for the captain, Dustin Brown, who gets it in deep. Smith comes out to handle it. Moves it to the corner. The Kings get to it first. Now Kopitar sends it to the near side. Scuderi moving in from the point. Ekman Larson gets there. Scuderi able to send it back in deep. Here is Kopitar with it. Kopitar below the goal line. Trying to spin away from Ekman Larson, who plays him well one-on-one. Oh, it's sent to the corner, and Martin Hansel jumped in there for the Coyotes.
Kopitar just had to make that a little bit of a firmer pass, and he had it down below.
I can tell you the energy level is really leveled out here. A bad line change here, but Phoenix gets away with this. Roosevelt slaps it away. Early on, it was all Phoenix, and you could tell that L.A. was reeling. But because of the Kopitar goal and the play of Kopitar's line, they have been that much better.
Let's go inside the glass, presented by Progressive Insurance. Here's Brian Engblom.
The playoffs are all about adjustments. When one team does something to you, you got to learn a way to shut it off, whether it's at the end of the period or the end of the game. Early in the series, LA Kings were getting access to the zone and got everything at Smith so he couldn't play the puck. In game three, and especially in game four, this is game four, LA couldn't carry the puck inside the zone. So look what happened. Mike Smith is making plays all over the place. Dumping in again, Mike Smith handles it, makes plays. LA never got their forecheck going the way they did. We've seen Mike Smith handling the puck again a lot in this game as well, too. That's all positive for the Phoenix Coyotes and something that LA has to change.
Dan Tippett, Panger, talked in glowing terms about the way his team played and handled the neutral zone in that game four win.
Well, a lot more composure, a lot more, if there's not a play, they didn't force it. They went back D to D to D to D, and it allowed them a little bit more time, a little more puck possession to enter the zone. And that's in the adjustment that LA had to make.
This puck doesn't come out. It is set up for Vermetta. Centering pass on the backhand. Didn't quite get through. Bakker now hands it off to Doan. He gets it back to Vermette. His shot was blocked by Mitchell. And Carter starts to back the other way.
There's the adjustment there. You see how high up Mitchell followed the man in the slot there, taking away Vermette.
Well, going to be a penalty here. Morris reached out and wrapped up Carter, took him down. And then another.
Vermette and Richards.
Yeah, Vermette took down Richards right there. I still think the only call is going to be the first one.
That's the second time, though, that Richards been slammed down pretty good. Now, it wasn't as vicious or as tough as the one when Shane Doan did it to him early on in the series, but he got thrown down on the backside there, and as feisty as Richards is, he doesn't like it. Here's a look at the penalty. See, it looked like Morris lost his footing, as well as having already wrapped one arm and his stick around Carter. That's a good penalty call. And then Vermette later, and see how Richards gets his feet taken out from underneath him. it's kind of a 1-2 punch. It was Vermette on the front side and Yandel on the back side.
Well, Richards finished his check on Yandel, and that's why Vermette came in. He took exception to the hit because the whistle had gone for the minor penalty on Morris for holding.
3.8 seconds remaining. Jared Stoll is marking out instructions there, where he wants Carter, where he wants Richards. There's enough time with a clean faceoff win. Tied up by Gordon. He slides it back smartly to Ekman-Larsson, and the first period will come to an end with still plenty of time remaining on the LA power play that will carry over to the second period. We invite you to stay tuned for the Coors Light first intermission. Liam, Mike, and JR will talk about the desperate play of the Coyotes early in this game and the fact that the Kings were out of sync early on and certainly got a big boost from the shorthanded goal of Anje Kopitar after the power play goal credited to Taylor Pyatt. Great saves by Quick kept his team in it. It is 1-1 after 20 minutes. The Coors Light first intermission report is on the other side of these messages. To Sedona, not far from Phoenix, Arizona. 1-1 is our score. Heading into the second period of Game 5 of the Western Conference Finals. Dave Strader, Darren Pang in the booth. Brian Engblom is our man inside the glass. There you saw the goal scorers. Pyatt for Phoenix on the power play. Kopitar shorthanded. And speaking of shorthanded, that's what the Coyotes are. Derek Morris in the box late in that first period for a holding penalty. And here comes L.A. with the power play. King still looking for their first 5-on-4 goal of this series. They have a couple of power play goals that came in Game 2, both 5-on-3s.
They don't seem too worried about their power play, even though, you know, the numbers aren't there.
Dustin Brown got behind the Coyotes. He was tied up, and that puck rolls in on Mike Smith. He's able to cover it as Dustin Brown looks over in the direction of Brad Watson, the referee, wondering how he stumbled here.
Roosevelt had a heck of a Game 4. He was certainly one of the unheralded players there. And it's Oliver Ekman-Larsson that actually trips up Brown there. Brown's there, and certainly trip by Ekman-Larsson goes undetected by the referee right there. Otherwise, he's in all alone. I mean, that's not only a penalty.
Yeah.
I mean, you can take a step further. He's in there all alone. Now,
he doesn't have the control of the puck, though, so I wouldn't go a penalty shot, but that was definitely a penalty.
Faceoff control by Carter. Doughty slides it across now for Richards. Back to Doughty straight away, looking for Kopitar. Top of the circle. Waits. Looking down low or cross ice. Nothing available yet. Now he sends it out to the line. Vermette got a stick on him, but it's held in for a shot that's stopped by Smith. Picked up right at the top of the crease by Slunko, and he sends it all the way down the ice.
Well, Carter looked back there at the referee. Looked like he might have got held up a little bit there. He was close. That rebound was sitting right there.
Here is Carter across the line. Hands it off to Kopitar. Two Coyotes on him. Now Carter there to help out. Wraps it around the boards. Far side. Richards at the point. Moved it quickly. Now Dustin Brown drops it back. Here is Doughty with a drive. Save. Loose puck in front. Slapped away by Gordon at the last second. Or Dustin Brown would have had an empty net. Here is Richards. Now for Doughty with a shot. That was deflected. And Smith is down.
That went off his mask. That went off. Smith was leaning to his right, getting away from traffic. And looked like he took that right off the lid.
Good heads-up shot by Doughty. It was. He's moving in. He can really fire it.
The first one with the rebound right there. Carter sniffing around on the rebound. That last one had a lot on it right here. Far side, Carter leans towards his left. Smith leans to the right, trying to beat around the traffic right there. Takes it right off the noggin.
He's been hitting the head twice, hard in this game. Dustin Brown had one, Brian, that you pointed out on the replay. Looked like it was destined to go into the bar. Now Gordon and Stoll on this faceoff. 30 seconds remaining in the Derek Morris penalty. Now it's picked up by Gordon. Slides it across for Korpikoski. Thinking about going against Mitchell, who slides it to his goaltender Quick. And the LA Kings get it back. Goal had it knocked away by Gordon. Picked up by Voinoff. Now for Justin Williams. Voinoff for Stoll. In deep along the boards behind Mike Smith. Now Kessler. Puck is knocked around the boards. Derek Morris is out of the box. Here's a shot that goes wide of a screened Mike Smith.
That one was dropping. It dropped about 8 inches on the shot from Williams from the point.
Here is Kessler, center ice. Sends it in deep. Quick couldn't get a stick on it. Now Doan knocks down Boynoff. Doan gets the puck back. Now it's slapped away by Jared Stoll, who was there to help out his defenseman. Now Boynoff has it again. Under pressure, it hits the skate of Vermette. Mitchell able to move to Jared Stoll, and he backhands at center ice. Justin Williams, who won a cup with Carolina back in 06. In fact, he had a goal in the clinching game 7 of that series. As Vermette backhands it into the LA zone. It didn't get very far, though. Helped along by Bodker. Richardson through the legs. Scuderi plays it off the glass and out to center ice. Oliver Ekman-Larsson. Center ice for Martin Hanzel. Hands it in on Quick, who steers it to the far boards. Hanzel gets in there to get a stick on it. Here's Rabada below the goal line. Rabada comes out. He goes high, hits the goal post.
During the regular season, he scored on a very similar play, waiting for Quick to go down and then going high.
And we pass for Rabada, and Doughty got a stick in there, and this puck goes out of play.
Well, Verbata was asked early in the series if the wraparound was available, and he says during earlier in the year, I faked the wraparound, and then I pulled back, and you see the goaltender already down and lunging forward, and goes off the side of Jonathan Quick. As he's going paddle down, there's no room down low, so he tries to get him cheating. It goes up just off the outside of the post and out of play.
He looks a lot sharper tonight than he has in any game so far, Verbata.
Yeah, no question.
Carter, center ice for Penner. Yandel gets a stick on it. Penner lost an edge. Rabada plays it around the boards. It'll be held in by the Kings. It comes to Green. A shot to the front of the net. Skips through. And a save made by Smith. Here's Martinez with a shot. He missed the net.
He was looking for a tip in there from Penner.
He had no shot at the net.
Martinez again with a fluttering shot. And that is stopped as Derek Morris and Dustin Penner really get into it. Wrestle each other to the boards.
Los Angeles, yesterday in their optional skate, they felt, at least Dustin Brown did, who doesn't normally go to the optionals. He worked with Bernie Nichols, a consultant with the LA Kings, and a great guy on the offensive side of the puck. They worked on tips, worked on getting closer to the net, shots to the outside. There's the tip. We've already seen one with Kopitar while shorthanded. Great hand-eye coordination there by Richards. And again, you reiterate how tough it is for a goalie to be leaning one way. You end up opening up a little bit, and then the puck comes back against the grain, just like Kopitar's goal.
You know, we saw it with Lundqvist last night on that Bryce Salvador goal for New Jersey, and guys in the studio did a great job of telestrating that.
There's 9,000 people in front of
him. Yeah. Dustin Brown now off the wall, hands it off, Boynoff with a shot, hits a skate, goes to the far corner. Shots are now 11 apiece. Go back the other way, sends it in deep. Kopitar works it to Brown. Coming down the wall, though, it was Roosevelt. They got a piece of it. King sent it back the other way. Here is Williams. Roosevelt ties them up. Brown lobs it to the front. Goes off a stick high and wide of the Coyotes' goal. Now Boynoff moving in. Boynoff puts it to the front. Deflects to the far side. Mitchell with it. And Vermette gets a stick on it, but it's still in play now. Kopitar's pass is deflected out of play. Let's go inside the glass, presented by Progressive Insurance. Once again, here's Brian.
At the beginning of the game, the Phoenix Coyotes came out and they controlled the game. But it was this guy, Andre Kopitar, and his shorthanded goal that really turned that around completely. But from the drop of the puck, the one guy that was going was Kopitar. When he had the puck, he made somebody come and take it off of him. And he was running at everybody. They were running at him. And then there was the faceoff when he gets it back, and he ends up with the deflection shorthanded. And it really turned the tide, and the rest of the LA Kings started to come along with him.
I saw the captain Shane Doan do that in a must-win game 4. And sure enough, that's why you have the letters. That's why they're leaders.
Now Kessler, checked by Stoll. Stepping in was Damon Lanko. Now Kessler battling with Stoll again. Coyotes able to win that battle. That's something else Dave Tippett talked about, winning those one-on-one battles along the boards and certain areas of the ice. Like the Kings were winning all those battles early in this series. Sent back the other way. Now here is King on the angle, try to sweep it to the front. Trevor Lewis backhand shot that was stopped by Smith. Out in the high slot area, comes out to Matt Green. His shot off the stick of Schlemko, who gets it now from his partner Kessler. Now Green able to hold it in at the line with the help of Richardson, and the linesman says it came outside. That was Jay Scherer's, the veteran linesman, who had a good look at that.
Well, we talk an awful lot about Mike Smith and how good he is handling the puck. Here he fires it the length of the ice, and it ends up being an icing call. Now, with the great plays that he makes, there's going to be mistakes along the way. This one's magnified and accentuated because it's while they're on the power play, and it's a shorthanded goal for Kopitar. So, I mean, to me, you take that little bit of a miss right there. As he handles the puck, he hardly makes any errors. That one got away from Shane Doan, who he thought he was going to while they were actually on the power play.
Yeah. But yeah, Phoenix was a little off that entire sequence, because even for the faceoff, they wanted to make a change.
Here's a chance fired up over the glove of Mike Smith, and there were the LA Kings winning a battle on the boards. Richard slides it across now for Mitchell. Pass intended there for Carter was blocked, and Voinov sends it into the glove of Mike Smith, who emphatically sets it down as he does. Now it bounces off of Pouliot. Penner took a swipe at it, and Pouliot recovers now for the Phoenix Coyotes. Pushes it in deep. Chipchura angled off the puck by Voinov. Pouliot comes in on the forecheck. Voinov moves it along. Schlemko picks it up on the wall. Sends it back toward Jonathan Quick. It's blocked by Voinov. And now Carter angles it off the wall, but it's held in. Picked up by Chipchura. Couldn't pull the trigger on the backhand. Hands it off to Klesla. His backhander blocked by Voinov. Rebound score!
Defenseman for the LA Kings, the right-hand shot. He turned and swatted at it. And it looked after the turnover there inside the blue line. Keep your eye on 26 in the white. As he turns here, spins, he maybe helps out. It is on the backhand of Pouliot.
Yeah, Pouliot had it on the backhand.
It's pushed ahead, though, certainly, and helped by Voinov, who gets it elevated and puts a little more mustard on it.
Yeah, that's for sure. A lot more mustard. But Pouliot did spin around. He was in the process of that backhand. Had a pretty good look at it from down here, right inside the pipe. So a real stunner here in favor of Phoenix.
First career playoff goal for Marc-Antoine Pouliot. Now here is Dustin Brown. Ellie has been so good following a goal. They come right back, and that one rings off the post to the left of Mike Smith off the stick of Dustin Brown. And back the other way now on the rush. Vermette has it stripped away by Williams.
It's tough to go one-on-one just inside the blue line for Doan there. Scuderi's very good at holding the line.
Here is Brown cutting in a centering pass, and Kopitar got a piece of that. Not sure if Smith had to.
No, he did not. It just went off of Kopitar's stick on a funny angle. He couldn't control the pass.
Now Justin Williams sends it across. It deflects up on the netting over the glass and out of play. You need unsung heroes to have success in the playoffs. Pouliot just that on this sequence here to give the Coyotes a 2-1 lead. Slava Voinov was in the vicinity trying to do the right thing when the Coyotes scored that go-ahead goal by Marc-Antoine Pouliot. It was Martinez holding a puck in, sending it deep now for Trevor Lewis. Morris tries to clear. Jared Stoll holds it in. Now Yandel wraps it around. Green sends it to the corner. Now here is Lewis with it. Trevor Lewis on the backhand. Turns, moves it to the corner. Yandel stepped up there. Green has it again, slides it across for Martinez. Martinez, a slap pass trying to get it to the front, but he was blocked by Morris, who then took him down out to the line. It's held in by Stoll. Here's Matt Green with a shot save made by Smith through traffic. You can sense LA just turning up the heat after they give up that goal.
Yeah, they're good at it, aren't they? They're very good at it. The response that they have, the way they come back, how hard they play.
Well, nothing will kill your will, as we get an offside here. Nothing will kill your will faster than when you score a goal and then you get scored on again right back, and LA's been really good at that.
Yeah, and after the goal, Dustin Brown went down the right side and rang one right off the post. Here's the backhand by Klesla. It goes off Voinov's shaft and his stick lies there. Now his intention is just to clear it to the side, but obviously the puck is slightly on the toe of the backhand of Pouliot. Quick gets sliding over to his left a little far because he thinks that's where it's heading on the original shot. So he's just slightly out of position on that far side.
Well, a big part of that play, too, was Rusty Klesla, who's been really aggressive and moving up. He's playing the right side again here. because O'Coin's not in the lineup tonight, so you've got two left-handers playing together, Schlemko and Klesla. Klesla seems to be more aggressive offensively on the right side.
Out rolls it on Quick. And he covers it up. And it all started with a bad clearing attempt, Hanger.
Well, it did. Carter, the right-hand shot, is up here. Voinov makes the play along the boards. Now, we stop it here. There's plenty of time right here, but instead of corralling that puck, it jumps off the blade as a right-hand shot. He's got his back turned. It slides off the blade, and right there, and Klesla ends up taking control of it here as he jumps in from the point position.
Well, that's the problem when you're the winger down the boards like that and you're facing your own zone. You're guessing the defenseman's coming. He wasn't.
Ekman Larson just wide, a rebound opportunity fired up over top of the net by Verbata, who slams his stick in frustration. And one of the other Coyotes had a chance just before Verbata did after that wide shot by Ekman Larson.
How many chances has Verbata had? That's why he's so frustrated and always high. Always over the net, it seems, on the great opportunities he's had.
Now Justin Williams trying to break free. He does. Centering pass, it's blocked. Great defensive read there by Michael Rosenwald as Doughty sends it across. Skinnari with a shot pass. Redirected into Zane Smith. Still loose. Now Smith has it covered and gets a whistle.
Boy, the shots from the point from the LA Kings are really good. They're smart. That was a terrific shot pass by Skinnari right on the tape of Williams.
Well, Daryl Sutter said it. He said if they're going to continue to block shots, we're going to have to do a better job of getting them through. And you see Ray Whitney goes to the forehand with a good little stick-on-stick slash right there on Kopitar, and this looked like it's intended off the end boards.
Oh, I think so. Hansel right there, good stick by Kopitar, or rather by Doughty. Oh, that doesn't miss by much, does it?
No, it doesn't.
I think the difference for Verbata in the first couple of games, he kept looking for opportunities, fishing around. Now he's going after the opportunities, and he's got a lot more desperation in his game. Even when it doesn't go in, he looks more determined to get the next one.
He's much more involved. I've even noticed him on faceoff jostling with guys like Mitchell. He just looks like he's engaged. And Smith plays this puck off the boards. Carter gets a stick on it now for the Kings for Richards. He bounces off of Derek Morris's check. Richards wanted to slide it across to Voinov, but it had to go through too much traffic, and it's sent back the other way. Bakker trying to chase it down. Mitchell steps into him, and Mitchell is checked in the play, and on the far side, Dustin Penner drops it back for Mike Richards. Richards carries into the Phoenix zone. Played well by Schlemko, and it's cleared by the Coyotes out to center ice.
Yeah, good defensive play by Willie Mitchell on Bakker, and then another good defensive play by Schlemko there on Richards, who's tricky one-on-one.
Now Stoll angles it off the boards. King trying to move in, but the puck taken away by Bakker. He hands it off now to Shane Doan, who plays it softly back into the LA zone.
You see how aggressive Green is on Shane Doan. Holds the line, takes away the man once he chips it. Doesn't let Doan go anywhere.
Lewis trying to get some speed going. Hands it off to Stoll. He mishandled the puck for a split second. And that broke up what could have been a pretty good scoring chance for the LA Kings. Now Chip Chura. Knocked away from him. They changed the assist, by the way, on the Pouliot goal. It's now Klesla and Chip Chura. Hansel definitely did not touch that puck in front as Nolan and Klesla collide down below us here as the puck goes deep into the LA zone.
That was a good hit by Nolan.
Now Morris will chase it down. Icing waved off. He moves it quickly around and got enough on it to send it all the way back down the ice. Icing immediately waved off. Now Green, center ice off the stick of Lanko, and a blocker save made here by Mike Smith. Gaudry holds it in. Now it comes to Colin Frazier. Frazier turns, pivots back the other way, angles it off the boards. Here's Doughty. Tees it up, he looks, gets the shot, and he scores! Another seeing eye shot by Drew Doughty has tied the game at two.
Doughty's so good at taking the puck off the boards, creating a better scoring angle. And again, we talk about the quick release that the Los Angeles Kings were talking about. They're going to keep getting blocked, change the angle, and fire it quick. Good play by Frazier behind the net, Brian. And then this one here has eyes.
There's no doubt. You would think that Smith would be able to pick this one up because it is coming from a long ways away. Watch him shoot between the legs of Pyatt, but that's still a long ways out. It's just as if Smith was looking for it in a different place and couldn't quite pick it up. I don't think it was deflected again, although it may have been. I wonder if that got deflected by Lanko.
No, I don't think so, but I think what Smith was doing, because he pulls it off the boards and he's a right-hand shot, Smith took the wrong lane, took the wrong angle. Once he brings it into his feet, he changes direction, and Smith lost track of it. You see Smith's arms afterwards? Looks up there like, I didn't see it, couldn't see it.
Offside here, Doughty's first of this series and second of the playoffs has tied this game 5-2. Time for Edward Jones FaceTime. Let's go to Brian Engblom on the Kings bench with Daryl Sutter.
Daryl, you've just tied the game back up. Do you feel like you've wrestled the momentum back in this game after an early start by Phoenix?
I think we had a good start to the period, right? Our power play came out and had a couple really good opportunities and got us going again. We still have some trouble with two or three of our forwards on the walls.
What are you looking for at this point?
Keeping it simple, very not looking for much other than shift by shift, trying to win a shift.
Thanks, Daryl.
Well, that one play that we showed you on the breakoff by Boynock, Carter wasn't strong on the boards, and those are the little plays. It ends up right on the tape of the defenseman.
Alan Frazier and Justin Williams got the assist on the goal by Doughty, so a fourth line forward. Frazier getting an assist on a goal just like Chipchura did. On a goal by the fourth liner Pouliot for the Coyotes. Jonathan Quick has given up three goals just once in these playoffs, and that was the lone loss in the opening round against Vancouver in game four. Other than that, it's been two goals against or less. So the Coyotes know they need at least three if they're going to win this one and extend this series. Ekman-Larsson touches. This is going to be icing here against Los Angeles or no? But the officials are talking it over.
Look at that communication there between the linesmen. Jared Stoll goes right over the veteran, Jay Shares. Shane Heyer also on the lines. Well, that was an animated discussion, wasn't it, Brian, right there?
Yeah, it sure was. And Andre Kopitar is really tired. He was coming to the bench like you read about here. So they're still trying to figure out if he can make the line change. I highly doubt it. I think he's going to have to stay out there. But this delay is helping him get a bit of a breather here without having to take a timeout.
Yeah, Bodker had to bring a new goal stick to Mike Smith, so that caused a little bit of a delay here for the faceoff. But it will be Kopitar against Ray Whitney. 7:51 remaining here in the second period. Justin Williams gets to it, plays it off the boards for Doughty. Cuts to the center of the ice, snaps it ahead. This is going to be icing. No, played by Smith. I don't know if one of the other linesmen weighed that up, but I thought it was going to be icing, and Smith went right back and played it.
I can hear yelling no down here. I don't know if it was Phoenix players or the linesmen.
Eric Morris's shot was blocked, and now Hanzo with a little bit of a shove, and then Whitney shoved off the puck. Yandle moves in from the point, overskates it. It's taken by Bravada. He sends it back in deep. Slapped that by Mitchell. It'll be chased down by Whitney. Hey, Whitney out near the line. It's knocked off the stick all the way back into the Phoenix zone, and both teams will make changes now.
Yeah, good pressure. I think Whitney wanted to curl up there and go back on a reverse to Hanzo along the boards.
Deflected center ice in the neutral zone. Picked up by Carter. He's got speed. Carter cutting in with a shot. Saved by Smith. Loose puck. And Richards got a swipe at it. Couldn't get much on it. And boy, the Coyotes want to be careful here again with a little extra curriculars after the whistle on Mike Richards.
Yeah, Carter looking five hole. Smith stays deep in his net. And he gets those legs shut down rather quickly from the right side. You see the angle, good position there by Smith. The rebound, it is loose. Good non-call by the referee, and it allows the second attempt right there. Squirts off the hands, now it squirts loose like a hot potato, and it gets paddled down, and some help from his D.
Great acceleration there by Carter coming out of that pack in the neutral zone, and Yandle had to do the crossovers and the backup routine as fast as he could, and he took the shortest route back to the net, just allowed Carter to go to the outside. Smart play by Yandle. He knew he couldn't catch up to him, and he knew Smith could make the save from the outside.
Off the draw, Carter, and a glove save by Smith.
What a face-off win that is. And again, the quick release of Carter. Richards, the left-hand shot against Lanco, the left-hand shot. Snaps it back perfectly. I mean, perfect execution and a great save.
There's a man who's motivated, perhaps, by that play off the wall in his own zone.
Another one right here, and that shot is blocked on the way through. It's backhanded by Kessler on the far side. Martinez sends it back in deep. Here is Richards, wrapped up by Schlemko. Quickly lets him go.
Oh, Schlemko's lucky he didn't get a minor there. He held on at first, and then he tripped him up.
Now Schlemko pitchforks it out to center ice. Green gets a stick on it. Carter is onside. It's picked up by Penner. Back in save. Rebound. Score! Richards, he put it in the second time for good measure. I thought the first one was in, but the LA Kings, for the first time in this game, have taken the lead. And what a play by Penner.
Quick step by Penner. The big man got his feet moving, exploded out of traffic. And we've seen in this series the hockey sense of Richards going pass off pad. But here the dump in back in. I think Carter thought that might have been offside. He hesitated slightly. Here's the jump by Penner. Shot on the back end off the far pad. That first one went in anyway.
Yep.
But Richards made sure by jamming home the second one.
That's the real play there, though, too, by Carter, right inside the blue line. He handles the puck in traffic. There's two guys on him, and he pokes it to an opening to allow Penner to come from behind with speed.
And again, it's so difficult to score, especially on the back end like that for Penner. That was a real mature play by Penner. You know, knowing it's not really a scoring chance, but it's a juicy rebound. It ends up being a goal.
First of the series for Richards is fourth of the playoffs, Brian. You talked about he and Dustin Brown as a couple of guys that dominated early in the playoffs and early in this series. And Richards has come back, but now here comes Ekman Larson with a drop pass. Gets one man down. Shot here, block, rebound, champ for Dome. Couple of pops at it, and somehow it stays out. And the Kings back the other way. Justin Williams with Dustin Brown, who falls down, and neither referee is biting on that one.
Oh, Larson was lucky he didn't get a penalty on that. He pulled the feet out from underneath Dustin Brown, no question.
That's twice now. They are not giving Dustin Brown the benefit.
Now Roosevelt lays it ahead for Doan, who just had a terrific opportunity to tie this game. Now Doan back to get it. Slides it across, Roosevelt hands it off to Chip Chura. Just over 5 minutes remaining in the second period. Shots are 21-15 LA. Now Doan, centering pass, was blocked by Mitchell. Picked up, what a move out of the corner by Chip Chura, then it rolled off his stick. Now Yandel, right back on the attack, hands it off on the far side, Pouliot. Wanted to drop it back, but a good stick by Willie Mitchell broke that up, and back comes Brad Richardson.
That's not the area to drop the puck. That 8-foot buffer just inside the opposition's blue line.
Not against Willie Mitchell,
no.
You don't.
Oh, he's so good at it, isn't he? Holds the line, the D of LA, Brian.
Yeah.
It's a clinic to watch how disciplined they are in holding the line and closing gaps.
Great stick by Willie Mitchell, always. It seems like you have to go about 15 feet around him in order to get by him.
Deflected in on Quick. He leaves it now for Green, who wraps it quickly out to center ice. Schlemko able to get there. Angles it off the wall. Lewis is going to hold it in. Here's Jared Stoll now. Dwight King. Well, you can sense the confidence of the LA Kings just rising with every passing minute of this game five. The shorthanded goal by Doughty, if the outcome of this game doesn't change, is going to be seen as the huge turning point. It was all Phoenix early. They had a 1-0 lead, and on the power play, as Richards across the line, cuts to the middle, gets a shot away, and then Trevor Lewis just sent it wide. Knocked away by Taylor Pyatt. He starts it back. Yandel, the defenseman, joining the rush. Pyatt waits, sends it to the front, score! Keith Yandel was there to put it home, and the Coyotes have tied the game at three.
You can see Yandel flying down the middle of the ice. Early in the game, the Coyotes did do a better job of getting the weak side D jumping in there, creating a little bit of an odd man rush. And Brian, from your vantage point, and is bouncing around, just one swat at it from Yandel?
I believe it even went off of Yandel's feet. He just goes so hard to the net. That's where Pyatt made the decision. I'm not going to pass it now. I'm just going to go to the front of the net. And it wasn't a very good job by Scuderi. I think Scuderi tried to play this with his foot. And Jonathan Quick nor Scuderi could get it. Yandel's right there. Goes down with his stick hard. But he's also got his feet there. See, it bumps in off his shin pad and scores the goal. That's a terrific move when they needed a critically big play by Keith Yandel.
Yeah, and they're taking a look at this for good reason. But it does jump up into the air. It goes off his shin pad. And he's not directing it into the net. I would have to think that this will be determined.
I agree.
A good hockey goal, as they say.
Yeah. He's going at high speed, just trying to time the pattern. Pyatt does a real good job here. And Scuderi, I think, is the one who got a piece. I'm not sure. Quick's coming across, but between the two of them,
It went off the right skate of Scuderi there.
There you
go. Then it went off the shin pad there of Yandel.
That's a good goal.
Yeah. There's no directing motion with either one of his feet. As you can see right there, both skates just stay on the ice as he's moving forward. And it bounces off of Yandel. That'll be his first goal of the playoffs this year, his third playoff goal of his career.
If you're the defenseman, Scuderi in this case, you got to turn around and take Yandel coming to the net.
Upon further review, the call on the ice stands. It's a good goal.
Well, this place goes nuts here at jobbing.com. 3-3 hockey game late in the second period.
Boy, was that huge momentum swing. Phoenix was in trouble. LA was really pushing after their last goal.
Did they ever? They had the complete push going on. No question about it.
Huge goal for Yandel, the Boston native, who played 1 year at Cushing Academy. As Ekman-Larsson angles it off the boards. Roosevelt plays it ahead. Now Doan able to get it through to Bodker. Bodker getting a bit of a pick for Vermette. Cutting in and rolls in on quick, and he steers it aside.
Fabulous play by Scuderi. What a recovery.
Here comes Williams now. Takes the big shot, trying to take it wide, puts it off the pad of Smith. Now Kopitar picks it up. 3 minutes remaining in this second period. What a pace we've had, and six goals between these two teams.
I guess it's the race to 4 or 5.
Yeah. Ekman-Larsson, good patience from the blue line. Puts it up high on quick. He just bodies it down to the ice, and Mitchell hands it off. Voinov off the boards for Penner. Taken off of his stick by Martin Hansel. Now Yandel, far side. Intercepted by Kopitar. That's going to be icing. He wasn't quite at center ice.
Well, Keith Yandel, his first goal of the playoffs, he starts it in his own zone. And Keith Yandel's best buddy growing up is Chris Bourque, the son of the Hall of Famer Ray Bourque. And there's the play with his stick. Keep your eye on number 3 in the red. He kept moving his feet and moving his feet. Center lane drive right to the front of the net. And yet, does he get a break? Sure he does. But he makes the effort to go from his own zone defensively all the way to the offensive zone.
The Coyotes' defense have been really aggressive in this game. On the check in the neutral zone and with the puck.
Here comes Carter. Goes to the outside, and that grazed off the side of the net after hitting the left pad of Mike Smith.
Think Carter got the message? Maybe following some words on the bench. After that turnover, he has been flying.
He is 1-2 here by Derek Morris. Then Penner is hit by Martin Hansel. Morris trying to dig it out of the crowd, and he does. First time that the LA Kings have allowed 2 goals in a period since game 4 of the series against the Vancouver Canucks. That's how tight they've been. Lunko plays it ahead. Martin Hansel gets this puck in deep, quick out to just settle it down for Mitchell. Minute 35 remaining here in the second period. An entertaining game 5 of the Western Conference Final. An LA win, and they will go to the Stanley Cup Final, which the NHL announced today will start a week from tomorrow. At the home of the Eastern Conference champion, either Madison Square Garden or Prudential Center. Martinez with a shot that missed the net. Now Green with it. Angles it off the boards. Here's Trevor Lewis. He hands it off for an attempted shot to the front of the net by Stoll that never made it through. Martinez quickly for Green. Green, a wrist shot. That's blocked in front. Picked up by Stoll again with a shot saved by Smith.
Oh, that puck is lined there. Smith's having a hard time tracking some of these pucks.
That one hit him up high on the shoulder. This one he covers up now with 54.7 seconds remaining in the second period. Yandel with an emphatic fist pump. His goal has tied this game at 3. Time now for the forward update. Dave Tippett wanted more guys to jump in offensively. Pyatt, Pouliot, Yandel, the goal scorers for Phoenix. Kopitar, Doughty, Richards for LA. Jonathan Quick. First time and just the second time in these playoffs overall that he's allowed more than 2 goals. That's how tough he has been and the LA defense has been throughout these playoffs. Out of the line, here's Kopitar. His wrist shot steered aside by Smith up high on the glass, bouncing puck. Recovered here by Dustin Brown. He turns, gets a shot away up high, save, rebound, chance goes just wide of the stick of Justin Williams. Good pressure here by LA in the final half minute. And now the puck recovered by the Coyotes. They don't get it by Kopitar the first time, and now Ekman-Larsson plays it ahead. Here is Doan against Scuderi. A little head and shoulder fake. Doan one-hands it, And a good stick by Kopitar prevented Vermette from getting that back to Klesla at the point.
Hey, Brian, another good defensive play there by Scuderi. Doan's not easy to handle down low like that.
Absolutely. He kept him. He gave him a little bit of a lead so he could keep him in front of him and then wouldn't let him cut to the net for anything.
And the horn sounds as Jonathan Quick took a look at the clock and made sure it was going to run out. And then Voinoff and Bodker get at it a little bit. Boy, this sets up a terrific third period here in Glendale. We remind you to stay tuned for the Discover Card second intermission. Liam, Mike, and JR will talk about the second period momentum swings. And the Devils over in the East, by virtue of their win in game four, have reduced the Eastern Conference final to a best 2 out of 3. 4 goals in the period, 2 for each team. It is 3-3 after 40 minutes of play. Stay with us for the intermission report right after this. Beautiful May evening here in the desert. 3-3 our score, LA Phoenix, after 2 periods of play in game 5. Let's take a look at the Lexus competitive edge. And the story of this series between these two goaltenders continues to be the guy on the left. Mike Smith has been the busier goaltender. He's faced a lot more shots, 7 more in this game. So he's faced 67 more shots now throughout this series than Jonathan Quick on the right. It's 3-3 heading into the third period, and the Phoenix Coyotes need to find some offense in the third. They have not scored a third period goal in their last 7 games. That ties an NHL record for one playoff year. Unless they go scoreless and take this to overtime, they're going to need one, as this is icing against LA.
Dave, you talk about the shots against the Phoenix Coyotes. Well, Dave Tippett has said all along, Mike Smith can handle those shots. We have given up a lot of shots from the outside. The ones he cares about are those rebounds and those battles in front of the net. And there have been some really good battles in front of both nets in this game. That's why there's been so much action.
Well, the faceoff deep in the LA zone. Coyotes Roosevelt, bumped by Dustin Brown, and Kopitar picks it up and starts it back the other way. Far side for William Doughty, joining the rush, and Smith does not give up a rebound.
That's a good, comfortable rebound, non-rebound there for Smith. But when you look at this hockey game, you wonder, how is he? This one, right, nibbles the temple. That one there, flush off his head. In the first period, we said during a timeout, he actually left the ice during a commercial break. He went in there with the trainer, scooted back out again. That's very uncommon. In that second period, he had 21 shots against, the most they've given up in a period by far in the playoffs. And there's a lot of stuff lying around there. He's got to be absolutely exhausted, and his head's got to be ringing.
Yeah, I would think he's exhausted for sure, Panger. I got a good look at him the last commercial break in the last period. If he's got something, he's hiding it well.
Now Whitney for Hansel. Carter stays with him. Carter plays it up the far side. Ray Whitney gets to it. Hansel off now for Yandel, who sends it back in deep. Hansel couldn't get to it. Whitney hustles over. Now back to the line. Derek Morse with a drive. He missed the net. Yandel holds it in. Hansel moves it along now for Whitney. Radim Vrbata has had several good chances in this game, but he's still looking for his first goal of this series. Now Richards chops at it. It's picked up by Keith Yandel. Drops it back. Hansel goes back to Yandel, and it's knocked away and cleared by the Kings out to center ice.
Yandel really wants the puck in this game. This has been, I think he's played with the most authority so far in this series, by far, in this game here tonight.
Well, Bukowski angles it off the boards, but it didn't get deep. It was blocked by the Kings. Dwight King pushes it back into the Phoenix zone. Schlemko wraps it around the far side. Chipped at by Taylor Pyatt. Pyatt with a second effort got it to Korpikoski, trying to go through Martinez, who got a stick on it. Oh, Korpikoski followed up with the hit, but he took down Martinez. It'll be called for a hold here.
Oh, an offensive zone minor penalty for Korpikoski. He likes to enter the zone with one hand on the stick, kind of flipping one way and flipping the other. Here he comes back in. Martinez gets in his way, but he's moving his feet. And then Korpikoski with one hand on his stick drags down Martinez going towards the bench.
Get live NBC National games right on your Verizon 4G LTE smartphone with Verizon 4G LTE NHL Game Center Premium. Call Star NHL to download today only from Verizon.
So getting your stick on one side of the player and then going on the other, you're going to get called every time. Whatever stick you choose to put, whatever side you choose to put your stick on, that's the side you have to attack, or you end up wrapping a guy up and take it too.
First minor penalty since the first period. Richards with a long-range shot. Brown was there. Loose puck is recovered by Ekman-Larsson, and he got it over the glove of Richards and all the way down the ice.
I thought Martinez did an excellent job, too. And Daryl Sutter talked about it. He said you can still interfere as long as you're moving your feet this day and age. And Martinez moved his feet, kind of went right into him, and it was a smart play by Martinez.
Now Richards. Slapped that by Roosevelt. Ekman-Larsson plays it around, and it takes a Coyote-friendly bounce off the glass and all the way down the ice.
Well, the other part of this, too, is in game four, the guy who had the most penalty-killing time of anybody, Lauri Korpikoski.
Yeah. Smith playing a little game of chicken there with Dustin Brown with that puck rolling near the area that Smith's not allowed to touch it. And the Coyotes send it all the way back down the ice. Now Gowdy hands it off. Justin Williams being pressured by Doan. Enters the zone and hands it off now to Willie Mitchell. Slides it along. Here it's stole for Voinoff. Sends it back in deep. Dwight King couldn't control it. Picked up an angle off the glass. Good keep in by Mitchell. Hands it off now to Justin Williams. Poked off of his stick, though, by Damon Lanko. And then Lanko able to one-hand it out through center ice.
A wasted effort there for LA after Mitchell does an excellent job of keeping that puck in on a hard rim by Morris. But they weren't able to keep it in the second time.
Voinoff now. Here it's goal. Drops it back. Here is Voinoff. Hands it off to Mitchell. He's it up for a shot. Save. Rebound given up. But it's the Coyotes that are there. And it's cleared all the way down the ice by Boyd Gordon. And the 15 seconds remaining of the Korpikoski penalty. LA has managed just two shots on this power play. 3.5 gone by here in the third period of game five. LA trying to earn a trip to the Stanley Cup Finals for just the second time in their 44-year history.
What a terrific job by Roosevelt standing up and poke-checking that puck away from Nolan, turning it over twice.
Korpikoski out of the box. The Coyotes back at full strength. Colin Frazier, Jordan Nolan's pass far side for Richardson. Hands it off now. Frazier couldn't control. Skinneri hands it off to Jordan Nolan. Now it comes to Verbata. Backhands it for Ekman-Larsson. Doughty timed it perfectly. Hustling back as Roosevelt. Three LA Kings are there, but the Coyotes come up with it. Ekman-Larsson, Verbata, then Whitney. Whitney across the line with Verbata. Waits, rolls it in on Quick, who steers it aside. Martin Hansel hands it back to Verbata, sweeps it off the side of the net. Verbata has it again. He finds Martin Hansel, and the shot is deflected by Scuderi up into the netting and out of play. Time now for the Coors Light Cold Hard Facts. And it has to do with most consecutive road playoff wins and spanning two seasons. The LA Kings, they won their last two road games last year in that first round series lost against San Jose. And of course, they're a perfect 7-0 this year. Ties a pretty good playoff team in the 82-83 New York Islanders. Face off to the right of Quick, Vermette and Kopitar. Vermette, who was hammered to the faceoff circle after two periods, won that one cleanly. And a leap pass up the middle and just unable to corral. That was Justin Williams. He would have been in alone from about center ice.
Did he take his eye off that puck for a split second?
Yeah, I think he did. I mean, what a pass by Kopitar in the backhand from deep. A read from Williams.
Here's Bosker cutting in. Jumps over and then quick made a stop on Vermette.
Holy jump, and he just robbed Vermette. Just robbed him. Vermette's got the open net on the glove side after Bodker leaps into midair, protecting the puck, going wide, finds the open space, nifty move. Keep your eye on the glove of Quick. Oh my.
How about the brilliance of this, though, Panger? Look at the speed with which Bodker comes in and the commotion and the concentration by Quick. I don't care about the guy who just jumped over my head. I'm going to stop this puck anyway.
You know, Jonathan Quick's having a quick conversation with the referee. Boy, would there spark a little bit of controversy there
if that goes in.
Asking about interference, but Bodker does a great job of trying to avoid the goaltender.
That was a holy jumping.
Yes.
Was it ever? Bodker's just been flying. That's a great play out of nothing, driving away wide and playing that game of chicken coming in off the wing. Am I going to go there or not?
Pouliot, who had his first career playoff goal earlier in this game. Boyd Gordon has lost his helmet. Taylor Pyatt is knocked down to the ice. No call coming. Gordon still without a lid. Now Chiptura. Chiptura looks to the front as Gordon is taken down. There's going to be a penalty now. And Mike Frank Smith realizes it. Tip to return, tries to send it to the front on a delayed call, and the Coyotes will go to the power play.
Garrett Stoll going to the penalty box after Gordon had got his helmet knocked out. They're coming over to look and see if Boyd Gordon is bleeding to see if it'll be a two or four. There's the initial hit on Chipchura behind the net on Doughty. There was no call on that one. Gordon had lost his helmet. There's Gordon in front. And watch the stick come around, and it's going to bonk him right up the side of the chin there. That is nasty.
Is that a double minor? Guess not.
Just two. Yeah, originally, I'm sorry, I thought it was Pyatt. It was 24 Chipchura that took that hit.
Well, two plays there. Certainly Doughty, by extending his arms and pushing Chipchura into the boards, was fortunate that he didn't get a boarding call there. And then you can see what Jared Stoll's trying to do. He's just trying to get on the inside and lift the stick. But he was on the outside. You go lift the stick and there's no leverage, huh, Brian?
Yeah.
Goes flush right up there against the chin.
Coyotes scored on their first power play, gave up a shorthanded goal on their second. They've not had a shot on goal on their last two power play opportunities.
Watch for Hansel deep in the slot again.
Hansel and Richards on this draw. And he stopped that one right away as Shane Heyer stepped in and says, nope, Hansel's going out. Verbata's going to take the draw now. He's a right-hand shot. And he sent it to the board zone, won it nicely.
Oh, quick hands.
Now Whitney under pressure, trying to get by Carter. Shuffles it along for Martin Hansel. Sends away from Green. Backhands it far side for Bada. One-timer Ekman Larson. Loose puck off of Quick. And it's picked up by Matt Green. He cleared it over the glass. This is going to be a minor penalty for delay of game with a minute 42 still remaining on the Jared Stoll penalty.
That's a tough play for Green. That puck is bobbling. It's rolling. He's just trying to get it out of the zone. And all Daryl Sutter can do is look at the veteran defenseman. There it's right here, little wrister, fluttering, and clearly over the glass. But Jonathan Quick made a phenomenal save just before that. And, look at the reaction of Quick. Oh, he's like, oh, man! 5-on-3, 3-3 hockey game. Power play here for Phoenix.
This could be the series, depending on which way this goes. Vermette and Kopitar on the draw, an important faceoff, and the Coyotes win it. Well, they can set up with a two-man advantage for Bada. Hands it off down to Vermette. Back to Vermette below the goal line. Two of them continue to play throw and catch. They're looking for an opening in front. It comes down to Dome with a drive and a save by Quick. Here is Vermette again. Steps out above the goal line. Patient with it. Drops it back down to Dome. Far side of one timer on the way. Save rebound. It's stopped by Quick. Here is Dome. Doesn't shoot it right away. Hands it off on the corner now. Antoine Vermette for Vermette. Vermette looking to the front. Goes to Vermette again. Down to Vermette. He walks out, hands it off. Ray Whitney now to Doan. Back to Whitney straight away. He and Doan change places. Now Whitney waits. Goes to Vermette in the corner. Under a minute remaining in the 5-on-3. Vermette above the goal line, and he hits the outside of the net. Now Vermette again goes to Shane Doan. To Whitney, back to Doan, a one-timer on a penalty coming. Going to be an interference call here as Kopitar was taken down. And boy, not what the Coyotes wanted to do there, but Martin Hansel, not much argument here.
I really like what Phoenix was doing here, Panger. Not the usual thing up top that almost every other team does. They were working behind the net back and forth, trying to draw the three defenders of Los Angeles deeper and deeper and deeper, which allows the top guys, Doan and Whitney, a chance to get open. Now, it didn't pay off for them, but it was pretty intelligent, I thought.
Well, keep your eye on 11 in the red right here. He goes into Kopitar, uses his right skate, and absolutely slew foots the big Slovenian. That's just a bad penalty for Hansel to take.
It's terrible.
Going out of your way to the high slot, and you can see that leg just swooping underneath.
Set the pick a little bit more subtly than that if you're going to do it, and that's what he was trying to do, create a little bit of room for Shane Doan.
And now it's a 4-on-3 for 40 seconds. That's the time remaining of the Jared Stoll minor penalty. He'll come out to make it a 4-on-4, and then when the Matt Green penalty ends, it'll be a one-minute power play for the LA Kings, a 5-on-4. So still a power play here for the Phoenix Coyotes, a 4-on-3. And now Doan taken away by Richards.
Oh, what a smart play by Richards. He had Shane Doan on his backhand, so he didn't panic. He knows Doan can't make as good a play on the backhand. He just waited, turned it over.
Here's Whitney, hands it off now. Gets it back, Ray Whitney. Settles it down, goes back out to Doan. Doan goes back to Whitney. Whitney waits, locks the puck. Now he lets it go, and it deflects off a player. Sent back to the front of the net by Bravada. Stole out of the box, it's a 4-on-4. Whitney realizes that. 12 seconds remaining in the Matt Green penalty, and then he'll come out to give LA a 1-minute power play. Stoll dumps it in wide of Smith, who nearly lost it there.
Great effort, though, by Kopitar and Richards.
That shot by Whitney coming in from the point is in if it doesn't hit Vermette's stick and go up top. Oh.
Well, you had a perfect angle of it from there.
Oh, I was looking right over his shoulder. I'm ready to go. It's in.
Yandel falls down. Power play here for Los Angeles. Pass to the front. Goes wide. Missed the stick. Ooh, Martinez may have gotten away with one there as Williams slides it across. Now here's Doughty. Doughty on the perimeter. Half a minute remaining in this L.A. power play. Across the zone now for Stoll. Settles it down for Justin Williams. Back for Stoll again. Straight away for Martinez. Far side. Doughty tees it up. That was blocked. Good stick there by Kopakoski. Now Doughty gets to the loose puck. Tries to jam it through, and Yandel able to get a piece of it, but L.A. recovers the puck. Trevor Lewis.
Good second effort there.
Martinez. Now to Stoll, back to Martinez. A shot that's deflected up on the netting with just 6 seconds remaining in the Martin Hansel minor penalty.
This is just great stuff right here. And here's the chance you're talking about, Brian, and your angle is perfect. Keep your eye on the stick of Vermette. The knee. Yes.
I knew it hit something. I saw his stick go parallel. Now, here's the look that I got. Whitney knew what he wanted to do. Look at that top shelf. Oh. It is completely open. Jonathan Quick is down and to the right side. Whitney knew it, and it hit Vermette in front.
Oh, that's a smart play by Whitney. He knows he doesn't have to get a lot on it because the screen's going towards the right.
Carter hands it off now. Boynoff with a wrist shot. Save off the pad. And picking it up now. Boyd Gordon, as Hansel comes out of the box, he goes to Bravada. Good job by Gordon to stay onside. Now Mitchell, shoved in the boards by Martin Hansel. Centering pass, but all white jerseys there. And Richards able to clear it for Los Angeles. Roosevelt battling with Penner. Whitney knocks it free to Martin Hansel. Back to Whitney on the far side. Ray Whitney cutting in. Heels back. Hands it off in front for Bravada. Knocked away from him. Ekman-Larsson waits and shoots, and that hits a leg.
What a block.
Straight away, Roosevelt. Back to Ekman-Larsson. Far side, a chance here. Whitney, the puck was in his skates. Now a bouncing puck is picked up by Richards.
Hey, what LA's putting on the line, though, in front of the goalie here.
Here's Ekman-Larsson's shot, blocked by Carter, and it's swept by a tired group of LA Kings back into the Phoenix zone.
Great block by Penner. He's hobbling going off the ice there, Brian, and another one by Carter.
Yeah, and then Richards wanted a penalty because he had a stick taken out of his hand, but his stick stayed in front of the net. He was able to go and get it, pick it up, and clear the pass. If it was in the corner, that wouldn't happen.
Dustin Brown now busting down the right side, trying to get it to the front, the wraparound, and Smith has it covered. Just shy of the halfway mark of the third period, Dustin Penner is in pain on the bench. Why? That's why. White out here in Glendale, Arizona, as we welcome you back to the Stanley Cup playoffs, presented by Geico. Game 5 of the Western Conference Finals. LA leading the series 3-1. Terrific action here. 3-3 is our score. Coyotes had a 5-on-3 that was shortened by a subsequent penalty taken by Martin Hansel.
Not a good one to take.
As Doan sends this puck deep into the LA zone. Kadri. Off the boards now for Doughty. Doughty lost his footing, picked up in the neutral zone. Now Bodker for Doan. Doan up the right side. Good job by Doughty. Centering pass in front of an open net momentarily, and Vermette couldn't get a stick on it. Now here is Bodker. Kopitar pushes it ahead. And Dustin Brown has it. Brown across the line. Makes a fancy move. He pulled it off at full speed. Now he sends it out to the line. Mitchell tees it up. And that is blocked by Doan. And it's pushed ahead by Roosevelt.
What a move by cover. Dustin Brown with the reverse toe drag.
Now Williams. Pushed to the boards by Roosevelt. Kopitar out to the line. Mitchell whips it across. Point off. A shot that got through. Smith the save. A bouncing puck. And it was played with a high stick, says the referee. 9:19 to go here in the third. It remains Kings and Coyotes 3-3. Tomorrow night, NBC Sports Network, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific. Coverage begins for Game 5 at Madison Square Garden between the Rangers and Devils. And if the Coyotes win tonight, back to L.A. for Game 6 Thursday night with our coverage beginning at 8 Eastern, only on the NBC Sports Network. Dave Strader, Derek Pang. Ryan Engblom is our man inside the glass. Coyotes are trying to force a Game 6 in this series, and L.A. is trying to earn a spot in the Stanley Cup Final. It's going to be icing here, I believe, yes, against the Coyotes. As we go inside the glass, presented by Progressive Insurance, here's Brian Engblom.
Dave, you talked about all the action in this game, and boy, has there ever been, but a lot of it has been in the front of both nets. The battling there has been a big story in the game. Defensemen trying to box out, wingers, forwards trying to get in there and get second and third chances that everybody has been talking about. That's the kind of stuff that makes a difference in a game like this. Winning and losing, that's what the players have always been saying. Yeah, we want more shots and we want more screens. It's all about getting to the blue paint and fighting for every inch.
Lemko plays this puck around, but Pyatt couldn't get to it, so it's going to be another icing call. And as we take a look at the shots on goal by period, the Kings with an advantage overall, but the Coyotes a little bit of a comeback after you see they were outshot 20-10, but as Brian Engblom pointed out, Dave Tippett's been saying all along, he doesn't concern himself with the shot totals that you see on the clock or on the stat sheet. He looks just at what he considers quality chances. And if that gets out of whack, then it's a concern for sure, as this faceoff is only controlled by Schlemko, who played it up the glass. Took a strange bounce off the partition there. And now it's angled off the boards and bounces into the Coyotes bench. And this faceoff, where's it going to be? I believe it's still going to be deep in the Phoenix zone.
We'll see if Phoenix makes a change on the blue line. Schlemko hasn't had much ice here in this third period. Had a bit of a struggle there through the first 40 minutes, taking over for Adrian O'Coin, who only played half the game in game four.
And there's a look at Rusty Klesla, who's played with Schlemko. Klesla plays the right side with Schlemko, and he kills penalties on the left side. I've watched Klesla closely in this game. Sometimes I swear he's getting confused on which side he's on, and it creates opportunities for LA. Oh, what a hit there by Doan on Brown.
Puck still deep in the Phoenix zone with just over 8.5 remaining here in the third period. Vermette sent it across for Bodker. Canceled off now to Rosabal. Rosabal long pass now for Doan. Wanted to go back to Bodker, but broken up by the Kings and Justin Williams at center ice.
And that's what you got to love about Kopitar. It just his defensive reads. We know he's great with the puck, but there he is. Third man high, helping out his D, reads the play, and pokes the puck outside of his zone.
Now Whitney trying to get this puck deep. It's gloved down by Scuderi. Across for Doughty, and he just quickly hoists it back the other way. Eric Morris now for Yandel. Quickly center ice, and it skips by a couple of players. And that's going to be icing on the touch-up by Mitchell.
That's a close call right there, as it's a little bit of a skipper through the neutral zone. Here's the hit by the captain, Shane Doan, as Dustin Brown's looking down for the puck. Dustin Brown takes the hit there. He's got his head down, bang. But he gets right back up and right back into the play. There's a play by Kopitar defensively.
Yeah.
Otherwise, Botker's got that with plenty of speed. Good read by Kopitar.
Hansel and Stoll on this faceoff with under 8 minutes remaining in regulation time in a 3-3 game. Whitney jumped in there with Dwight King to negate the faceoff that looked like it was going to be controlled by Los Angeles. What a battle for this puck. Finally, Hansel kicks it to Whitney, and Whitney hoists it back toward the LA zone. Mitchell across for Voinov. Now off the stick of Lewis, and that's picked up. Oh, Verbata just offside as he picked it up.
They had Voinov caught in the neutral zone there, too. That could have been trouble for the LA Kings. Voinov was up near the red line. That faceoff could have been a quick outnumbered attack for Phoenix.
Quick call there, but no reaction by the bench of the Phoenix Coyotes. And there you clearly see that he had not come out of the zone.
And touches it. Yep.
Touches it before. Good call by the linesman.
We mentioned these referees and linemen are trying to earn their way to the Stanley Cup Final as well.
I made that plural because I wasn't sure which one made the call.
Yeah, that's right. Now Yandel able to hand it off to the centerman, Boyd Gordon, who came down low to take that pass. Chipchura and Pouliot crisscross, and that is offside. Saturday, Major League Soccer continues on the ABC Sports Network. It's a rematch of last year's MLS Cup Final. Houston looks for redemption against Beckham and the Galaxy. Saturday at 2:30 on the NBC Sports Network. We saw David Beckham among the many celebrities at the Staples Center in Los Angeles.
Why wouldn't he be a Monte Kopitar fan?
Now Bunker into the zone. Hands it off. Backhand shot. Save made by Quick. Declan Larson. Puts it along. Bunker got a stick on it. Now Williams slides it across and took a hit right by that LA bench.
For my money, Bodker is making more plays than most guys from Phoenix.
And he just stepped into Dustin Brown, and now Ekman Larson angles it off the boards.
Yeah, he's taking his game to another level. He's, I think when the Phoenix Coyotes look and evaluate their players, they look at a guy like Bodker and say, wow, he's gone there to the area that we're thinking he'd go to.
Dave, and a rebound given up by Smith, but he quickly swept it aside. Now it's taken back by Kopitar. Couldn't quite gather it in. He wanted to move it quickly, I think, to Justin Williams on the far side. But Kopitar angles it off the board. Doughty with a drive. That's into the glove of Mike Smith, and he will hold it there.
Yeah, the traffic couldn't get in front of the net. It was boxed to the outside. I'm sure Doughty wanted somebody there because that one's too easy of a shot from that far away for a goaltender this level. Only four main guys remaining stopping pucks, but look at the protection here. And Brian, I can imagine how difficult it would be for a defenseman like Roosevelt to get the puck off the big body of Kopitar there.
Yeah, that's true. Doughty didn't get all of that shot. He was kind of drifting away from it, so there wasn't much on it. But when you have Kopitar that protects the puck so well, it's hard to lean on. You have to control him. You can't expect to strip him of the puck all the time.
Here's King now. Behind the net, tried to go short side. That was blocked by Mike Smith, and now Taylor Pyatt able to clear it out to center ice. Stoll drops it back to Martinez. Stepping up in the neutral zone there was Plesla. A little confusion down below us here, but Stoll came up with the puck, sent it back in deep. Lemko, nice little outlet pass for Damon Lemko. He slides it across, the pass found the seam for Taylor Pyatt. He takes it wide, gets the shot away, it's plucked up high on the glass, and ends up out of play. A faceoff in the LA zone when we come back. Under 6 minutes to go, 3-3.
Well, Radim Vrbata is an opportunistic goal scorer, and he gained a lot of confidence while playing under Wayne Gretzky while he was the coach here, and he's obviously carried that on with Dave Tippett. A number of glorious chances. This is a good blocker saved there by Jonathan Quick, and then on the wraparound, he fakes like he's going to go tight, fades away, and rings it off the pipe on the short side. He certainly has had his chances here tonight.
He is out there with his line mates, Martin Hansel, Ray Whitney, Yandel and Morris back at the point. Stoll, Lewis and King, the line out here for Daryl Sutter defensively with Mitchell and Voinov.
Linesman's trying to tell Jared Stoll, okay, let's settle down, put the stick down first.
He does, so does Hansel. And it is controlled by the LA King centerman Jared Stoll. And here is Dwight King. That bounces off the skate, it's picked up by Whitney, turns it back the other way, throws it to the corner. Voinov and Vrbata come together there. Now Jared Stoll hit by Martin Hansel. Mitchell slides it ahead. It's backhanded and onto the stick of Dwight King. King trying to drag it. It got a shot away and swiping at it. And just missing was Voinov, who followed up on the play.
What a play by King.
Now Whitney plays it ahead. Vrbata tried to chip it in deep. It was blocked by Scuderi. And back the other way, Richards broken up by Derek Morris, who stood up nicely. And a little lob pass the other way, trying to break through is Taylor Pyatt. Picks it up for a shot, just missed. And the Lanko now, he has it on the corner. Lanko behind the net, centers, and missed firing was Korpakoski.
Oh, what a chance that is. Terrific play, down low, and boy, Quick getting down low, trying to cover the high part. Lanko with a little stutter step there, and a perfect, oh, goes off the mask. Holy jumping right off the forehead of Jonathan Quick.
And how about Dwight King with that little one-on-one move, that little hesitation move, and then protecting the puck, going wide and getting it into the paint. When you're as big as Dwight King is, that's a great move to make. Yandel had his hands full there, but using his head, Jonathan Quick, that was outstanding.
Faceoff controlled by Vermette. Here's Roosevelt, shot to the net. Hits the skate of Kopitar. He gets a glove on it, but it's picked up by Bodker with a shot. Loose puck in front of an open net momentarily, but the Kings dig it out. And back the other way, Dustin Brown. Just got his head up in time as Roosevelt stood up on him.
Kopitar shaken up. His battle level has been brilliant in this game. He was shaken up. Oh!
There's a player on the bench over there in Phoenix's side.
Fraser, but knocked right over the boards.
Alan Fraser was in the Coyotes bench. Now it comes center ice, and it's picked up by Boyd Gordon. Jordan Nolan takes a hard run at him. Green picks it up off his goaltender. Sends it out center ice. It deflects off Richardson. He'll pick it up. Coming up on Schlemko. Off of his stick, a bouncing puck. Richardson sweeps it in wide. And picked up by Rusty Klesla, who hammers it off the board. Center ice, Martinez across for Green. Green dumps it along the boards. It jumps over the stick of Smith. Klesla got good position. Orpikoski for Schlemko, who sends it center ice. Why not push it right back in? That hit the stick of Klesla and forced Smith to have to come back and play it. Orpikoski wanted to go to Martin Hanzel, but missed on the pass. Now it's Schlemko who recovers. 3:45 remaining in regulation time. Coyotes trying to extend this series. LA trying to earn a berth in the Stanley Cup Finals for just the second time in franchise history. Mitchell up from behind his own net. That bounces off a Coyote. Here is Bravada for Hanzel. Tries to get it to the front, but it's covered by the goaltender Quick.
Whitney was all alone in front of the net, but Hanzel couldn't reach far enough and get enough leverage on that pass. Here's the hit by Bodker on Fraser. Down goes Fraser.
Oh, boy, they got to be careful of these skates, right, guys? Yeah. I mean, oh, wow.
Jay Sharz does a heck of a job. The linesman comes right over and makes sure that nothing funny happens while Fraser's down on the ground and nothing did. And then Voinov comes across and puts big-time pressure on. That was a terrific play by Voinov, because you're right, Whitney was all alone in front of the net.
On control by the Kings. Penner. Able to tie up Yandle. Actually had a stick knocked out of his hand. Here's Carter closing him with a shot. That was blocked by Morris and set up over top of the net to the far side. Doughty with it. Down low now for Richards. Sends it out to the point. Scuderi lobs it in wide. It bounces in front of Smith and he'll cover up and hold it for a faceoff in the Coyotes zone.
That's why you try to direct everything close to the net. That was just a redirection there. Great hand-eye coordination by Carter. Innocent looking shot from the point position after Richards does a nice job of getting it back. Here, this is 15 feet wide, but that redirection is enough with a bouncing puck. Yandle there and Penner hanging out to the left side of the goaltender.
Well, offensively, the overtime mentality is already on. Get everything to the net. You never know which one might go on to make the difference.
Kopitar and Gordon. Kopitar arguing that Gordon's the one that's cheating here, and now the faceoff.
Yeah, because Gordon's got to have his stick down second.
Now it's blocked by Doan, trying to push it ahead on Scuderi. Scuderi, boy, just another solid defensive play under pressure. Split second decision there, and Scuderi makes the right one again. Now it's sent deep into the Coyotes' end with 2:40 remaining here in regulation time. And this is whistled down by the linesman, Jay Shears.
It's an icing.
Oh, it is an icing, okay.
And it's been the negotiation went on. Shane Doan looked right at the linesman, it's icing. Williams is looking at the linesman saying, it's not icing. And I'm sure Daryl Sutter's, well, I think I can tell you what he's thinking.
Doesn't change his demeanor, his expression much though, Banger, you're right. Now Vermette and Kopitar on this draw, and Kopitar wins it cleanly. Doughty. Angles it up the far side. Justin Williams drops it back for Scuderi. Far side for Williams again. That's blocked off of one of the Coyotes. Ekman Larson. Here's a lead pass for Doan. Top of the circle with a drive. And look how far out Quick is. And he covers that up and there's no rebound.
That's been the turn of this series and allowing Phoenix to get back into it is their stretch pass. But after Williams takes the hit, it doesn't get in deep. Bodker quickly turns it up ice. And this makes for an easy one here. The only way for Doan to score is to try to fake it and go wide a little bit, a la Daryl Sittler in 1976 in the Canada Cup.
Wow.
But that's a tough one now with stick on puck, the way the defensemen play that kind of shot.
Yeah, and Mitchell was closing down on Doan so quickly, it would have been tough for him to fake because Mitchell would have been right on top of him in another two steps.
Mike Owen still now with 2:26 on the clock in the LA zone. Nice job by Stoll. Point off, far side. It's chipped by the Kings out to center ice. Klesla drops it back, and that bounces off of Taylor Pyatt offside.
Well, Jonathan Quick, has done a marvelous job in this game, going east-west. The Coyotes are making him work. There is no question about that. This is the hardest he's had to work in this series. Plenty of action in front of him. He's made just such timely saves. Forget about the goals against. It doesn't matter. It's about the last save that you make, and he has just got such a strong competitive spirit about his game. I'll tell you what, his trainer, old Jay Mountain over there at Fast Fitness in Connecticut, gonna be pretty proud of the way this guy has battled through this game, because it has been a hard game in front of that net.
That save he made with Bodker literally jumped over his head, and he kept his concentration for the second shot. I think may be the most astounding one to me.
Hustle will chase this down. That cans it up the boards, goes off the glove of Verbata to center ice. Martinez sends it back in. The LA Kings have to go back and tag up, which they do. But the puck was played by the Coyotes with a high stick. So inside of 2 minutes, as you see, remaining here in regulation.
And those are key moments. You know, that's an easy out of the zone. Now it's a face-off in your own zone. And it looks like we got Mike Richards on the dot.
Boyd
going
Gordon.
Up against Gordon, and here's the negotiation. See Richards talking to the linesman here.
Richards and Gordon set. Gordon won the draw. Morris to Yandle. Wraps it around Taylor Pyatt. Chipped it off the wall, but it came at an angle where the LA Kings were able to get to it. Good second effort by both teams. Now it's picked up by Richards. Closing in. Goes wide. Shoots and a save. That may have hit the mask as well. Comes out the point off, and he misfires on a shot that would have been a great scoring chance.
It was rolling.
You know, this puck out of play, and I think the faceoff is going outside. Boy, how many saves have these goalies made with their heads in this game?
That's how good the masks are. That's how good they are. They're great protection. You get a lot of courage when you've got protection like that, for sure. But it looked as if the Coyotes had the puck. An unbelievable play there by Richards. As he buys some time, he waits and waits and double clutches, and that allows him a pretty good shot from the angle.
And it was Penner along the wall who made a terrific play on the wall to keep the puck in play and knock it over to Richards so he could make it to the net.
And that was flush right off the front of the cage that's attached to the mask. That's the third good solid one that Smith has taken to the head.
Very far side. It bounces off of Williams to the neutral zone. Boy, what a battle by Doughty, though, to make sure that Doan doesn't turn that into something going the other way. And here comes Dustin Brown now. Swept off his stick momentarily by Roosevelt, who then pins the LA captain to the end boards. Out to the line. Here's Scuderi. Slides it across for Doughty. Waits, and now the shot is blocked by Vermette up into the screen out of play. We're down to 1:02 remaining in regulation time.
That's the right play by Vermette there. Don't let Doughty into the middle of the ice. Doughty loves to draw it, whether it's 5-on-5 or on the power play, draw it into the middle of the ice and get a better angle. Terrific stick positioning there by Vermette.
The pressure's on. Doughty's incredible with his composure and his will to want the puck. You know, you want to be that player. You want to be on the ice in the final moments, whether you're leading, whether it's even. You just want to be that guy, and he's had a heck of a hockey game.
Yeah, Doughty stands in and inside the offensive blue line with the puck in traffic like few guys I've ever seen.
Face up and a hand pass here. The LA Kings controlled it, but I think the linesman, Shane Heyer, spotted a hand pass, a subtle little one there. It's going to bring this faceoff back outside the Coyotes zone.
Jared Stoll gets down exceptionally low on those faceoffs. He's got great leverage when he gets down there like that. Turns his hand over so he can bring it to the backhand.
Right in front of the Coyotes bench. Trevor Lewis gets it deep. Derek Morris hustles over to get to it. Hard around the board, but nobody in red is there. It skips away from Mitchell, and the speedy Korpakowski almost got to it. Now in front of the LA bench. Flipped ahead, but it's blocked by Yandle. Patient with it, slides it across for Derek Morris. Morris from center ice, hammers one in on quick, gave up a big rebound. And it's sent the other way. This is going to be icing? No, Penner's going to get there to negate it. Oh, Derek Morris flips it over the glass.
That's it.
Derek Morris under pressure flips it over the glass with 26 seconds remaining in regulation time.
It's a huge turn of events here. What looked like was going to be icing gets nullified by Ekman Larson. And then Morris grabs it, and you can see again as he's about to release it, the puck goes on end and flutters and over the glass and a power play. And looks like this was going to be...
Great effort by Penner.
What a great play.
Faceoff control by the Kings out to the line. Doughty slides it across. And knocked away by Vermette out to center ice. 16 seconds remaining in regulation. This power play, of course, will carry over to overtime if the LA Kings fail to score here in regulation. Kopitar for Richards, cutting in across. And Kopitar was tied up there by Ekman-Larsson. Dustin Brown working against Gorbakovsky, sets it up, and a save made by Schmidt. And the puck cleared to the corner as the horn sounds to end regulation. What a stop by Mike Smith as the LA Kings come close to ending it in the dying seconds of the third period.
Richards comes in for support, but Brown slides off the boards and gets it for the one-timer to Carter. Kopitar's banging in front of the net. And you see the stick work there, the big juicy rebound, but good protection by Roosevelt.
That's all about body position by Roosevelt. Terrific job.
Overtime intermission powered by Subway is coming up. Liam, Mike, and JR will talk about the missed chances that lead to overtime. The Kings' road streak on the line as Phoenix now has gone 8 straight games without scoring a third period goal. If the Kings score the next goal, they're in the Stanley Cup Final. If the Coyotes score it, we'll have a Game 6. The guys with the Subway intermission report right after this. That is Westgate outside Jobbing.com Arena here in Glendale, Arizona. The crowd is not outside yet because we still have some business to finish inside. Dave Strader along with Darren Pang, and the 7th overtime game for the Coyotes. Remember, they started the playoffs 5 straight overtime games against Chicago, so they've got a little bit more experience. The only overtime so far for the LA Kings was when they clinched it Game 5 in Vancouver.
You think about it, though. This is why it's you put every single thing on the line. Every time you can get a stick on a puck, every time you can block a shot, every time you go down and finish a check, every time you do the little things, it's the difference between the LA Kings going to the Stanley Cup Finals for the first time since 93, or with their backs against the wall and no tomorrow, the Phoenix Coyotes can keep this series alive. This has just been a phenomenal hockey game. Exciting to watch, end-to-end action, great goaltending, great stuff.
And a minute 34 remaining in the Derek Morris delay a game penalty that came when he cleared the puck over the glass. So let's see if the LA Kings can get it quickly into the Phoenix zone. They do. Dustin Brown chases after it. Moves it now to Carter. Quickly around now for Kopitar. Kopitar in the corner. Sends it back to the line. Here is Doughty. Tees it up for a shot. And that deflected up high on the glass. Still in play. Dustin Brown moves it quickly. Taken by Kopitar. Back to the line now for Doughty. Slides it across for Richards. Now to Kopitar again. One-timer Doughty. No, he faked it. In the skates of Richards, but he controls it again. Richards takes a look to the front. Still has it. Jams it out, and it went through everybody and passed Kopitar at the point.
That's a situation where Doughty was telling me this morning that he liked to slide up to the left side a little bit more. Richards goes down low, but it would create a one-timer from Doughty, but it never happened.
Hard rim around by the goaltender Smith. Doughty kept it in, but a good stick by Doan. Now at the line, it is picked up and sent by Lanko all the way back into the LA zone, and Quick will settle it down there with just over half a minute remaining in the Derek Morris minor penalty.
The reason they can move over on Doughty like that for the one-timer and take it away, because if he passes to Richards, Richards doesn't have a one-timer.
Williams puts it right through the blue paint. Now back on the far side, it bounces hard off of Williams, and it's angled off the boards and out by Kleslin.
Boy, Mitchell might have had a chance to hang in there on that line and keep that puck alive, but he backed up, maybe fearing the speed there.
Here is Stoll to the front of the net, bounces off a skate. Schlemko gets a stick on it, but Stoll gets it right back to the line. Here is Mitchell for Jarrett Stoll. Hands it off down low. Williams to the front of the net. Loose puck down to Smith, and the puck squirts all the way out to the high slot. Derek Morris is out of the box. The Coyotes have killed it off, and they're back at full strength, but the pressure still on in the Phoenix zone. Here is Mitchell. Waits, sends it in deep now for King. King, big body protecting the puck, throws it right through the goal mouth, and Richards on the far side picks it up. All Los Angeles out to Voinov. Puck was in his skates, he couldn't shoot it. Now picked up by Richards again. One hand on the stick for King. Now he gets control, angles it off the boards for Williams. He sends it out now to Scuderi. Straight away Voinov toward the net, it goes in wide. Now Williams again. Rolls off his stick. Bravada able to clear it softly back into the LA zone.
This could be icing.
Oh, it is going to be icing.
Now Williams in front of the net at the tail end of the power play. Keep your eye on 14 in the white from the right side of your screen. He's going to come sliding in here on the jam play, fake the shot. He ends up in front of Smith. Smith comes over there, gives him the stinky leather mitt right there.
Smith's so calm there. He does a terrific job here. Look how calm he is. He just very calmly slides across, controls it, and then, oh, yeah, gives a couple of whacks up the side of the head to Williams. Oh, you're going to come in my paint, huh?
And Dave Tippett has called his timeout. Here in the first overtime, it's like the second period. It's a long change, and Tippett had not used his timeout during regulation.
Well, for Dave Tippett, the Phoenix Coyotes used to playing tight games early on against Chicago. And you see that tip in there, blocked from a sharp angle on Corey Crawford, and then one that unbelievably slides underneath the Chicago goaltender. Game one against Nashville, a set play off the faceoff, well executed by Hanzel to the veteran Ray Whitney.
A little conversation going on here with the referee Brad Watson and one of the Phoenix Coyotes, that's Yandel.
All the little details make all the difference in the world in overtime. And one of the details is that each team is farthest away from their bench. And especially with Mike Smith's ability to move the puck up the ice very quickly and perhaps catch LA. Here's a look at the icing call. They thought, Phoenix thought it went off of Mike Richards. Yeah. And I think that's what the argument was about.
Well, here's the faceoff. Hanzel able to win it. Alperbata pushes it ahead. Slemko angles it off the boards. And Doughty able to go to Scuderi. Plays it ahead for Dustin Penner, who gets it in deep.
And immediately, Brian, Slemko jumps off the ice. He was caught on the ice on that icing call, so he was quick to get up the ice and get a change.
Here's Whitney. Oh, a stick comes up in the face, and the LA Kings got away with one there. Hanzel definitely took it up in the face, and neither referee saw it. It was Dustin Brown's stick that came up. And now Doughty.
The Phoenix bench is very calm, though. That's important to be, yep, have that kind of demeanor in an overtime.
Gadari hands it off. Penner lifts it back the other way. Ekman-Larsson able to get it to Bravada. He drops it back now for Rosenthal. Center ice. Ray Whitney across the line. Whitney patient with it. Waits. Now tries to dump it to the front. And a loose puck is recovered by Richards. He hands it off calmly for Carter, who bangs it off the boards to center ice. Rosenthal moves it quickly there to Ekman-Larsson. Tried to drag it back to himself, but it was blocked by Richardson. Now Richardson for Richards, and it's broken up, picked up by the Kings, and a shot here doesn't get through. Rosenthal angles it off the glass, and it skips off the stick of Boynoff. Taylor Pyatt going in. Mitchell gets there first. And an icing call here.
Well, Marty Hanzel snapped his head back here. As you see this, see that the stick blade got caught under his arm. And then there's been a lot of talk about embellishing and flinging it back. And I'm not so certain that stick actually caught
it. Made it all the way, yep. That's right.
And it's been a lot of conversation between Dave Tippett, Don Mullen, everybody in the NHL talking about we got to keep that snapping the head back out of the game.
Here is Green with a shot to the net, deflected, and the left pad of Mike Smith just got on it. And now here is Lanko trying to push it ahead, but the Kings got a stick on it. And turning back now, Boynoff for Green. Hammers the puck along the boards behind Smith. No, it didn't get back there. It was blocked along the wall, and now Taylor Pyatt backhands it wide of Quick. Korpakovsky moves it to the near side. Lanko knocked away, and right out in front of Jonathan Quick, stole is there. Jumping up was Derek Morris. The puck is held in by Lanko. Now he lets it go in wide, and Quick able to cover up with Pyatt. And Korpakovsky right there.
Well, the little things in the game, Brian, are going to be so important. As you well know, that Jared Stoll getting low on the backhand right there. Misses it the first time against Lanko, but then gets it the second time. Whoa! Just off the side of the net through traffic. Smith never saw that.
That happens so often. It's not the clean win a lot of times that makes a difference in faceoffs. And the other thing, too, is wingers coming in and helping out, or defensemen in the defensive zone, and those loose pucks that are only a couple of feet behind the centerman.
Kopitar wins the draw from Vermette. Now it comes to Justin Williams. LA's had the puck on their stick for most of this overtime. Here's a shot right into the midsection of Mike Smith. He'll hold it there 4.5 minutes into this first overtime period.
Easy save there for Smith. No rebound.
Shane Doan out there again. He's had a boatload of ice time in this game. A lot of miles on him. A lot of bumps out there. He and Andre Kopitar, the most ice time of all the forwards on their respective teams.
Face off in the Coyote zone. Kopitar and Vermette. Vermette wins it cleanly, but Williams gets there first. Now Kopitar again. Into the boards. Still able to control the puck. Sends it out now. Scuderi couldn't pull the trigger the first time. Hands it off for Williams. High slap for Brown, and it missed his stick, and Doughty has to hammer this puck back in behind Mike Smith. Look how quickly he gets back in there to settle it down for Ekman Larson. Left wing side for Botker. Botker starts it up the ice. Pushes it ahead with his speed, protecting the puck. Now puts on the brakes. Wanted to hand it off, but it's blocked back out through center ice. And Williams hands it off there for Dustin Brown. Brown coming in. Backhand shot. Good stick by Ekman Larson. Broke it up.
Good recovery there by Ekman Larson, getting on the inside. Brown trying to keep it to the backhand right there, but stick on puck knocks it up over the glass.
And the reason he had to recover is because he's arguing with Justin Williams. Coming out of the zone, Williams and Ekman Larson have been tied up completely with each other, and that's why Ekman Larson was slow getting up on the play. Then he has to come back and do a good job, as you said, of getting his stick in. But it all happened because Williams, that's why the crowd was booing and going crazy in behind the scenes, is because Ekman Larson wasn't allowed to get up on the play because Justin Williams had his stick between his feet.
Boyd Gordon gets low, wins the draw, able to move it now to Derek Morris, who backhands it along the ice. Deflects off an LA stick, and it's recovered now by Carter. Coyotes still without a shot on goal so far in this overtime, as this deflects in behind Mike Smith. He settles it down there. Yandel wraps it around the glass, bouncing puck skips away from Richards and Voinov. And Quick will come out to play it for Voinov. Slides it across Willie Mitchell. Mitchell throws it into an open area in the Phoenix zone. Yandel back to play it. Derek Morris moves it around quickly for Botta. Now for Martin Hansel. Drops it back for Radim Vrbata. Pushes it ahead, but it didn't get very far. It is sent back into the Phoenix zone. It's going to be icing here. As we take a look at the one overtime hero of these playoffs for the LA Kings that came in Game 5 in Vancouver.
Yeah, similar situation, although a win doesn't advance you to the Stanley Cup. But here they were able to finish off Corey Schneider and the Vancouver Canucks with a wicked wrister by the former Edmonton Oiler, Jared Stoll.
Right now, Stoll heading to the bench, as you see. It'll be Richards to take this draw for L.A. Gordon leans in for the Coyotes. He shares the veteran linesman, making sure that it's a fair and clean face-off, talking with Richards. Now he drops the puck. Ends up off the far boards, chopped at. Good keep in there by Klesla. Now Chipchura drops it back. Klesla wanted to move it along. It was blocked by Penner. Now Klesla again moves it along in deep. Willie Mitchell back to get it. Chipchura on him. Now here's Voinov. The Richards off his stick, and Klesla drives it right back in. Quick moves it to Voinov.
Good hesitation there by Voinov, getting away from the first forechecker, Gordon there.
Now pushed in deep, and Pouliot, who has one of the Phoenix goals, hands it off to Schlemko. Left wing side for Chipchura. Chipchura far side, but too far for Klesla, and the LA Kings take over. Phoenix making a change, but they need to hurry. Now Green will dump it along the boards behind Smith. Up the far side, bounces off of Lewis, recovered here by Dwight King. King turns and angles it off the boards. Martinez sends it across for Green. Green with a shot. Green directed, saved by Smith. He wasn't sure where it was for a moment, but now he covers up.
Good play by Lewis down low, and that results in Martinez going over there to Green. Again, this shot was off to the side, looking for that redirection, opening up the legs of Mike Smith. There was the keep in by Lewis. Good spin around there, play by King, D to D, and watch where the shot is. On the outside, redirection, the stick, the skate, and then the goaltender Smith's able to cover it up.
So now it'll be Kopitar. Leaning over the faceoff down against Antoine Vermette. Shane Heyer talking to Kopitar. And Vermette got the faceoff win, but Williams got to the puck. Sends it around the board. Scuderi throws it back in deep for Williams. Williams for Kopitar. Ekman Larson trying to use his reach. It goes out to the line. Scuderi through traffic. And it was blocked in front. Picked up backhanded just wide of the Coyotes' goal. And Roosevelt back the other way. Finds Vermette in the middle of the ice. Hands it off for Botker. Botker wait, looking for somebody coming late. Now Botker to the middle. Drops it back to Ekman Larson. Rolls it in deep. Doan couldn't get a stick on it. Dustin Brown on the far side. Now Doughty. Poked away from him, but it's All white jerseys around the puck. As Williams will hammer this puck behind Smith up the far side. Oh, a lot of LA players around that bench as that puck was touched. Now it's picked up by Penner. He wanted to turn to the forehand and make a play with it. Now it's knocked away from Carter and picked up by Shane Doan. Doan has Whitney. Wanted to go instead for Ekman-Larsson, but the pass was broken up by Mike Richards. Richards, a long pass here, bounces off of Penner, hands it off to Carter. He couldn't control it cleanly. And Keith Yandle turns with it. Forced back by Carter, who goes to the bench on a change up the middle. Just misconnecting there with Whitney. No icing, though. Oh. And now the puck over the glass, and is this going to be out of play, or is it a deflection?
Voinov thinks that this is icing. So he just chips it up over the glass and out of play. It doesn't matter if it's whatever. It's a delay of game penalty. You see, the original play here, it's waved off, but Voinov thinks it's icing. And this just goes off his blade.
Well, they're bringing the faceoff outside the zone.
Oh, yeah. Now Phoenix sees the replay up on the clock as well, too. Banger, I agree with you completely. Voinov thinks it's an icing. So we let up a little bit. Boy, did they get away with one there. And Phoenix is not happy on the bench.
Phoenix still without a shot in this overtime as it's hammered by Schlemko around the board. Picked up now by Kuliak to the corner for Gordon. Matt Green fell down, but he gets back up quickly. Now Chipchura able to move it to the corner. It comes back, though, to Martinez. And look, Martinez now for Dwight King. King pushes it ahead into the Coyotes' end. Schlemko was there. Plays it up the boards for Klesla. He pushes it to Boyd Gordon. Back for Klesla. He tries to get it deep, and he does. Quick settles it down. Matt Green pressured there, but still able to move it. Now Martinez just hoisting it out to center ice. Coyotes trying to get the ice tipped in the other direction a little bit and get some kind of an offensive push going. Now Pyatt trying to push it ahead. It gets by Green, but he recovers to get a stick on it. Now it's picked up by Martinez again. Pressured by Pyatt, rolls it to Green. Hands it off for Kopitar. Oh. Bumped by Lanko, busting through though. Dustin Brown takes a look over his shoulder to see who he has with him. Lanko pins him to the glass. Now Kopitar protects the puck, sends it out to the line, but it comes outside the zone. And Scuderi has to back up, and the LA Kings have to go back on the attack. Williams sends it in deep. Smith comes out to handle the puck. Roosevelt got there up the far side. Korpikoski took his man. The puck got by Richardson. It's going to be picked up by Pyatt. Pyatt cutting in. Lanko wanted to go back to Pyatt. Picked up by Ekman-Larsson, and that was blocked just wide. Now back the other way. Williams pushes it in deep. First good opportunities for the Coyotes as Smith to Derek Morris. And Morris just lifts it back through center ice. Bouncing puck. Mitchell has it.
That'd be on the little too pretty route right there. Chance to shoot the puck on an odd man break. No chance. No scoring chance.
Held in by Nolan. Trying to push it to the front. Now Morris on him. Morris getting good position on Nolan. Nolan getting some help, but coming over to help out Morris is Antoine Vermette. He steps it back the other way. Left wing side for Bodker. Bodker could not get the puck deep, and it's sent back the other way. Carter with speed picks it up. Carter on the angle with a shot. Saved by Smith. He took a quick look over his left shoulder.
Well, he wants to make sure that that's not dribbling in behind him. I mean, a lot of people think, oh, that's a shaky move. No, that's a sharp move. When you can feel it inside your elbow, and if you're not feeling it, it might just be dribbling behind you. So a quick shot short side, and he looks and he says, I've got it there.
Well, Jeff Carter was a late line change. Nolan was late coming out of the zone, and he was slow. He was so tired. So Carter gets on late. And then, oh, here's the play before that. Richardson on the line change. See how he got tweaked up because of the power of Pyatt? Pyatt just spins Richardson around. Dowdy comes across and makes a brilliant defensive play. He waits and waits, comes across, keeps his stick in the passing lane. I know what you mean, Panger, about not taking the shot. Lanko didn't have a shot. Dowdy played it perfectly.
He might have had a shot if he made the perfect one over Doughty and right up under the bar. I think he made the right play, but he didn't get it airborne over the shaft of the stick of Doughty. That's brilliant defense by Doughty.
Well, let's take our viewers back that might be joining us late to see how we got here. Six goals scored, one each in the first period, and it started on a deflection there on the power play by Pyatt, and then shorthanded. Kopitar got that one. Then it was Pouliot for the Phoenix Coyotes. Doughty came back again, and then right after that, Richards' first one went in. He made sure on the second one. And then Keith Yandle driving hard to the front of the net. And as far as career overtime heroics, Jared Stoll with two, Kopitar with one, Bodker has two in this round. Whitney has a couple, Doan, Hansel, Pyatt, and Roosevelt have one each. As good as Bodker's been, though, right before that Carter chance, Bodker doesn't get the puck in deep. Looks like it's going to be a chance, and nothing happens. He just turns it over.
Yeah, and those are the areas of the ice. You've got to be so sure about that gray area inside your own blue line, the gray area, obviously, just inside the other team's blue line. There's plays that you mismanage are awfully magnified when they don't turn out well. See, Smith's doing a lot of stretching down there, Brian. Taking his time here, doing a lot of stretching.
We don't have any TV timeouts, but the players at least get a chance to get a blow, and they clean the ice up a little bit, which is certainly equally important as well, too. And Smith really taking his time here as he was doing some extra stretching in the crease.
And now it's Richards and Hansel on this faceoff, and Hansel wins it cleanly. Yandle wraps it hard around, but it doesn't get by Richards. Penner one-handed it. It bounces off the skate, picked up by Derek Morris. Morris pinned along the wall, and now it's cleared by the Coyotes. They're trying to get to it is Whitney. Doughty's going to be called for interference. This is a tough one on Doughty because he's going to say he already had that ice, and he's entitled to it, but not agreeing.
He better stop. He better settle down.
Kevin Pollock, the referee.
Oh, Pollock just turned around like that's enough. One more thing, and he's got an extra two at least.
And Rob Scuderi's just gone over to Doughty, and he's shoving him over there. You can understand the emotion here and the passion, but the puck is already by him. He goes out his way once, but he releases. Then he goes again, and then he goes again.
And if it wasn't interference on the original step over, then he's already got the ice, and I can see his argument. Like, right there, if it's not called, now he's entitled. But now you see the arm go up. He's got a little bit of an argument there, I think.
I do, too. I think he's got an argument because he did keep his feet moving. He was on the inside, and he's also saying, hey, the guy's holding my stick. But it's a done deal now.
So a power play for the Phoenix Coyotes. They've scored once on the power play, but LA also has scored shorthanded earlier in this game.
Doughty's still losing his mind in the penalty box.
Puck is controlled by the Kings. They dig it out of there, and Matt Green has a little escape with it and send it all the way back down behind Mike Smith.
It's what we were talking about with Daryl Sutter. He talked about interfering, that you can if you keep moving your feet.
This puck deflects off a stick up into the seats and out of play. And the faceoff.
And not like the old days, huh, Brian, where just get your skates in the tracks and you just latch on to guys.
Yeah,
but
for sure.
There, for sure, Doughty with one hand trying to release, trying to go. I mean, you know, that's been called. I wouldn't be able to give you the percentage of that, but we've seen that called and we've seen that not being called. I'm not talking particularly in this game, but throughout the course even of the regular season the last few years.
Usually in those situations, it goes to the offensive guy. They're more likely to call it than not, from what I've seen.
It's a gutsy call this time of the game.
Sure.
Ekman-Larsson, rink wide for Pyatt. Minute 20 remaining in the penalty to Drew Doughty. Power play here for the Coyotes in overtime. It bounced off the side of the net, and the Kings were quick to get to it and send it down the ice.
Yeah, alert play there by Brown. You've got to be quick on it there. He turns, spins, and fires it right out of the zone after it hit the side of the net.
Whitney pushes it ahead. Shane Doan hands it off to Bodker. He gains the line for Vermette. Vermette wraps it around the far side. Doan will get to it first. Sends it back to the line. Whitney goes back to Doan. Now the Coyotes have it set up with a man advantage. Whitney walks the line, hands it off to Ekman-Larsson. Ekman-Larsson to Whitney, winds up. He goes to Doan. Doan to the net with a hard shot that's blocked up on the glass. Knocked down by Vermette. Now picked up by Bodker. Mitchell right on him. Aggressive play by Mitchell. Knocks the puck all the way back down into the Coyote zone. And we're just over half a minute remaining on this Phoenix power play.
Heck of a shift by Mitchell. One, a big shot block, and then he hacks and whacks and gets the puck out of the zone.
Mitchell has to move up there. It's a smart play on the sequence on the power play for Phoenix because they rotate around, and it draws the two forwards for LA across the blue line, and then they throw it back to Doan, which means Mitchell has to move up there.
Derek Morris kind of faked the dump in and then shot it toward Quick. It worked once earlier in the series, but now the Kings will send it all the way down the ice. Final 5 seconds on the Doughty minor penalty. He's getting set to come out of the box, and he does. His penalty is over as Yandel moves away from Justin Williams. Carries all the way into the LA zone. Gets a shot away. Quick gave up a rebound. Bouncing puck. First to it is Williams. He'll chop at it and get it out to center ice. Roosevelt has it there. Lenko drops it back now. Roosevelt. Now hands it off to Yandel. Far side, Korpikoski. Trying to push it ahead. Again, the Kings do such a great job of getting sticks on pucks. Now Korpikoski tried to jam it along the wall. It was blocked by the Kings, and Scuderi hands it off for Anze Kopitar. Across the line, little soft pass for Williams. Save made by Smith. Covers up. No! Look at Rebron! He's got no glove! He's got no glove at all. Here is Green trying to get it to the front. Kopitar drops it back. Now Kopitar has it. Mike Smith without his glove. It's behind the net. Here is Green with a shot.
I can't believe they're not blowing this down.
They blow it down for sure if he doesn't have the helmet, but I don't think there's anything in the rule book about a goalie that doesn't have his glove.
I haven't seen anything about that rule. I don't think I've ever seen that before.
Smith able to get his glove back, but he better hurry. Here comes Dustin Penner, and the play was offside because of the line change. A player over at the bench, and then Penner and Roosevelt come together.
And then Smith wants to know why the play wasn't blown down. Hey, that's my hand out there, brother.
That's where we'd like a mic on the referee in that situation to see what that conversation is. You know, I know in my playing days, which was a while ago, there's times where you do lose a glove, but I don't ever recall for an extended period of time like this. Remember in the playoffs in 94 when Mike Richter made that great save? He had lost his glove and he had his arm stretched out on the goal line and made a magnificent save. Well, here, this has got to be incredibly uncomfortable as he uses his bare hand to get his balance off the post. Oh! And boy, Williams, with all that going on, Williams has the easy wraparound right there. Rolls right off the end of his blade.
But Strays, I'm with you. I mean, I know of no rule that says you stop the play just because the glove is on. I mean, players lose them all the time. I understand it's different for a goaltender, but still, there's nothing in the rules. Helmet, yes. Glove, no.
Carter knocks it down, what they say, with a high stick.
Well, at the end of this play here, just a one-handed little tap there by Penner and Roosevelt. We'll see if there's anything vicious about this. Not whatsoever. Roosevelt goes down trying to sell that. Oh, boy.
Well, you wonder if the general managers will have a conversation seeing a play like that. Boy, you lose a goaltender to a broken hand on a play like that. I think the whistle should blow. Here's a long shot that is collected by Quick. Off the stick of Schlemko, he'll hold it there.
Yeah, but it would have made for some kind of dramatic sequence if he would have caught the puck.
No. I disagree. I disagree with you. That's part of the game. It is what it is. He would have had to try to make a save with his arm or whatever, or if he tries to make a barehanded save, that's obviously going to cause him some great damage there. I don't want to see that. But if another player loses a glove and he does the same thing,
I think it's different with a goalie. Same thing with a helmet. A player can lose a helmet, play continues. Goalie loses a helmet, it doesn't continue. But that'll be a discussion for another time as we have a face-off here with 5:29 remaining. And Lenko stepping in across from Jared Stoll.
I would just put my glove on a little tighter. There's a strap underneath and it'll keep it snug in there so you don't lose it.
Now on the far side, King, pressured by Klesla. Puck goes back off the boards behind Quick. Now Lenko got to it, moved it around the boards. It comes to Dwight King. Checked by Klesla. Puck kind of took a funny bounce toward the middle of the ice. And it's picked up by Stoll, sends it across. Kings outside for a chance here, and a save by Smith. Loose puck, Hustle tried to slide it into Smith, but Smith was unable to control it. And Korpakowski gets a stick on it, and it bounces off of Jared Stoll out to center ice.
Boy, it looked like King might have wanted to go high to the far side there. Maybe didn't get that high enough.
You bet, Panger. That's exactly what he wanted. He hammered it, though.
He sure did. Good play by Voinov to chip that puck ahead. And here's the shot, left-hand shot, yep. Trying to go against the grain, but doesn't get it up high enough.
He went for the volume so hard here. I mean, you know, you could see even in slow motion how hard that shot was. He needed about two or three more inches on the outside, but at high speed, that's tough to do.
Situation room in Toronto verifies that, yes, only with the helmet off would the whistle have blown. There's nothing in the rule book to cover what happened, even though it was Dustin Brown that knocked the glove off of Mike Smith. As this puck is sent in wide of the Coyotes goal, and Roosevelt, and a backhanded up the boards, it was blocked. Ekman-Larsson goes to Bonker. Bonker, that is blocked again. Sticks on pucks, bodies on pucks. Bonker hit by Dustin Brown, and now it rolls in deep along the inboard. Dustin Williams gets to it. Fell down as he tried to make a play, angled off the boards. Not a good outlet there by the Coyotes. They had a chance to get it out of the zone, and they failed to do it. Now Vermette, pressured by Dustin Brown, rolls it ahead, and without a stick. Did that come outside the line? Drew Doughty is sure
he
did.
See what Doughty thinks about that.
Oh, boy. His emotions right now, as you can see, wears them right on his sleeve. And I thought he kept this in. Hey, you know, these linesmen are the best in the business. We'll see from the...
He kept it in.
He did keep it in right there. See, you got Bonker going. It's offside. You got Doughty sour like you read about. That it's inside the line. It's inside the line.
Yeah. But look at the key part there. Bonker has no stick.
Yes.
If that's allowed to go on, Bonker has to get back inside the zone.
Absolutely.
That play goes on, and you're playing against 4.5 men instead of 5.
Just over 4 minutes remaining here in this first overtime as Mitchell drives it around the board. Smith got a stick on it. Now it's chopped at by Yandel, but stopped by Carter. Sent back in deep. Carter has it again now. Puts on the brakes. Martin Hansel comes back. Steps into Carter, but Richards has the puck. Now it jumps over both the sticks of Hansel and Carter. And it's cleared out to center ice by Derek Morris, and the LA Kings have it again. Voinov plays it ahead. Yandel stops it from getting deep. Slides it across now for Morris. Up the middle for Martin Hansel, who couldn't control it. Quick stops it and hands it off now to Mitchell. Mitchell, far side. Penner lifts it high in the air. And knocked down by Whitney away from the onrushing Carter. Whitney on the far side now. Here is Korpakowski, accelerates, tries to turn back on Penner, who just squinched him into the boards, and the Kings able to clear it back inside the Phoenix blue line. Off the stick of Lenko. Now Lenko has it again. Gips it into the LA zone. Voinov lays it back up the wall. Stepping up there was Lenko, but Stoll able to get it to Dwight King. Now for Lewis. Lewis inside the line, knocked away from him, and it's picked up center ice by Matt Green.
Great job by Schlemko there, staying on that play, and terrific stick to knock it out.
Hard around the boards by the goaltender, and it's picked up now by Lenko. Now Klesla up the far side, and that deflects out of play. And the key word is it deflects after it was off the stick of Klesla. So no penalty here with a faceoff deep in the Phoenix zone, and 2:43 remaining here in the overtime.
And Brian, with Klesla being a left-hand shot, as you mentioned, playing the right side, he's forced to go on his backhand. The problem is he can't see that there's no winger up there along the left side of the board. So he's really dumping that right to the left D of the LA Kings, and there was no coverage by his own man there.
Yeah.
He was fortunate right there.
Yeah, and the Kings are smart. They realize when they get a guy over there on his backhand side, they're going to keep him there and force him to make that tough play.
Aesop goes to the end boards. Here is Brown with it. Backhand wrap around loose in front, and just failing to get a good wood on that shot was Kopitar. Roosevelt, extra move at the line. It's offside, and then Brown runs into him, and
Roosevelt hurt.
Yep, he is hurt. Ekman-Larsson and Doan both come over. And the question is, I don't see anything from the referees. This is an offside play, but
the Phoenix by it, and the Phoenix bench is yelling, it's a knee, it's a knee. Brown is coming across in exactly the opposite direction of Roosevelt, and the whistle goes a second before the hit happens. Roosevelt's got his head down.
Oh, wow.
Ekman-Larsson Larson goes right over there to Brown. Keep your eye on Brown's knee and whether it doesn't move from its original place.
It looks like it's full body contact, and yes, the leg is separated. He uses his leg and gets leverage on him, gets his knee inside in between the legs of Roosevelt, and it looks like the thigh on thigh, knee on thigh, and Roosevelt didn't see it coming, so he was never able to brace himself.
Yeah, and obviously, you know, Brown's been the middle of a lot of stuff here in this series and through the playoffs. This is a bad injury for the Phoenix Coyotes. You cannot underestimate how good Roosevelt has been on the blue line.
Absolutely.
He's been a horse playing with Ekman Larson. They've gone head-to-head with the Brown, Kopitar, Williams line. Boy, he can't even put any weight down there.
Yeah, it's difficult to tell whether it's knee or whether it's his thigh, but that collision was violent, no doubt, with two guys going opposite directions.
And the one player, Roosevelt, would lay up a little bit knowing that it's offside. And here it's offside. And then at the same time that whistle's going, you see Kopitar is going the same direction, and then Brown comes in. Obviously his skates, we stop it there. He's trying to get him with a left shoulder forearm, but his left knee goes right into the middle of the body, and knee on knee or knee on thigh, as you mentioned.
Brad Watson is the referee, having an extended conversation with Radim Verbata. Ray Whitney down there as well for the Phoenix Coyotes.
See, for me, he didn't lead with his
Yandel
knee.
Yeah.
For me, when you get a kneeing call, he didn't lead with his knee. He comes across, he makes contact in the upper body as well, too. And yes, there was a violent collision, leg on leg. But for me, it was full body, and it's one of those unfortunate injuries.
Here comes Carter, closing in, save, rebound out in front of Tim for Penner. He scores! Dustin Penner ends it in overtime, and the LA Kings are going to the Stanley Cup Final. Well, the Coyotes are arguing that there may have been a hand pass on the play, and they're also upset about the play that led to Michael Roosevelt having to leave the game.
A little delay here in the celebration because of that. Here's the face-off. Quick little pass. There is Voinov's about to take a hit. Penner with the backhand pass, the shot. They're saying maybe got gloved right there by Richards on the first rebound attempt. Thought it might have gone right beyond his glove. And then right on the tape to Penner, who fires that high and over the glove. And in the net, quick release there by Penner. And the teams are shaking hands, and the Los Angeles Kings are heading to the Stanley Cup Finals for the first time since 1993.
And a tough way for this to end for the Phoenix Coyotes, with everything that happened in the moments leading up to play resuming, and then that bang-bang play. The Hansel having words with Dustin Brown, and it's not all just congratulations there. They're upset about that play, there's no question about it. Dustin Brown, though, a great competitor, the captain of this team. And Shane Doan, not happy about it. He's letting him know. He is letting him know.
Yes, he is. There's no question. Marty Hansel and Shane Doan had a pretty intense, animated, short conversation there with Dustin Brown.
Well, the last time I remember something like this happening, Panger, remember that horrific hit, Claude Lemieux, on Chris Draper, and those guys had to shake hands after the series ended, and it was a very difficult, emotional situation for Detroit with Claude Lemieux. And that's what this game is all about. You have to handle those things in the moment. And the Coyotes have a long time to think about this, as Quick and LaBarbera have some words there. Jonathan Quick, terrific. And just for the second time in these entire playoffs, giving up more of the two goals, and Dwight King getting congratulations from Shane Doan and Dave Tippett.
Pretty hostile environment right here, but you see Smith and Quick, and great words for two outstanding goaltenders, great competitors, and certainly Mike Smith. Man, he just had a phenomenal, phenomenal season and a phenomenal playoff, and the same with Jonathan Quick, and great of Shane Doan recognizing that, and Dave Tippett, Jim Playfair as well. It's a great young goaltender.
Dustin Penner's first goal of the series, his third of the playoffs. There was the Clarence Campbell Bowl that is coming out. Dustin Brown, the captain, will be skating over, and there's always conversation about whether the captain touches the conference championship trophy or not. Some have done it. Some are superstitious. Daryl Sutter, tremendous respect from the veterans on this Phoenix Coyotes team. Shane Doan was very respectful of what Daryl Sutter said about his hit earlier in the series against Trevor Lewis. Well, right now for the post-game trophy presentation, let's go to PA announcer Paul Sura. The PA announcement here, and how about the Phoenix Coyotes? With everything this franchise has gone through, bankruptcy declared in May of 2009. They've been owned by the National Hockey League for the past 3 years. Threats of the team moving, threats that these guys are going to be uprooted from a place that they love to live and love to play. And through all that, they battled hard here against the Los Angeles Kings. Now, let's go to the public address announcer, Paul Sura.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, NHL Deputy Commissioner Bill Daly will now present the Clarence Campbell Bowl to the Western Conference champion Los Angeles Kings captain Dustin Brown.
Dustin Brown with a handshake with Bill Daly, and it doesn't look like the LA captain is going to touch that Clarence Campbell Bowl. And now the LA Kings know that they have some time off. A week from tomorrow, they will open either in New Jersey or at Madison Square Garden in New York. The Kings play just one game against each of those Eastern Conference teams. Of course, remember way back when the season began in Stockholm, Sweden, it was the Rangers and the Kings that opened the season then. And later on in the year, it was the Kings playing the New Jersey Devils. But right now, Dustin Penner, the overtime hero, is standing by with Brian Engblom.
Dustin, you're the overtime hero here. Just tell us what you saw in that play and how it developed on the winning goal.
It starts off with a neutral zone draw. Ricky gets a second effort to win it back to Slava. He throws it up the boards. I got a lucky bounce pass. Yandel get the puck, drop it. Karts, he throws it on net, and I just wait for it to settle down enough so I can put a shot on net.
You're going to the Stanley Cup Finals. What's going through your mind right now?
It'll be nice to go back. I've been there once before early. I didn't get to enjoy it probably as much as I should have. And this time I'm going to take it all in, and hopefully I'll get the same result.
You guys haven't trailed very often in the playoffs and certainly in this series, but you were trailing a couple times in this game. What was the emotional level like for you guys?
I think the first period was tough. They came out, threw everything at us, scored the first goal. And then when you're playing catch-up, it's very tough mentally. Quickie hung in there for us, made some big saves. And then we just got some timely goals, got the lead, and then it was anybody's game after the third period.
What was the emotional level like here leading up to that last sequence? Just a big hit by Dustin Brown. Everybody was angry out on the ice.
Yeah, it's a tough break for Phoenix. It's tough on the refs. I don't know if it was knee on knee. It looked more like thigh on thigh to me, but you know, sometimes you need those breaks.
Last thing, a word about your goaltender, Jonathan Quick, in this game and in the series.
You mean Vezina Smythe? Yeah, he's been unbelievable. You know, he's worked so hard to get to the level he's at, and it's not easy to get to the level where he's at. It's even harder to stay there.
So, thanks, Dustin.
You bet. Thanks, Brian.
Dave.
Well, Dustin Penner certainly raised his level in the playoffs, and that's what players have to do, and he's probably the best example of a guy going from one level in the regular season to what he did in the playoffs. The Bud Light postgame report is coming up. Liam, Mike, and JR, the Kings advance to the Stanley Cup Final. Doughty key in an elimination game. So that'll wrap it up here from Glendale, Arizona, and the Jobby.com Arena. In overtime, the LA Kings win it by a final score of 4-3, Dustin Penner is the overtime hero. A reminder that tomorrow night, Coverage continues in the Eastern Conference at 7 Eastern, game 5 between the Devils and the Rangers. Coming up next, as we mentioned, is the Bud Light postgame show for our man inside the glass, Brian Engblom, for my partner in the booth, Darren Pang, and the rest of this great crew that we've had just a lot of fun working with and bringing the games to you throughout these playoffs. I'm Dave Strader. Thanks for joining us. The Kings to the Stanley Cup Final.